Hey everybody, welcome to episode 15 of Her Majesty's Council. It's the usual crowd, but we've got PND's 12 gauge on the show today. How's it going, my friend? Thanks for coming on.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm doing good, I'm doing good. How are you doing, Gabe?
I'm good, how are you?
Cool, I'm doing good. I'm doing very good, actually, despite what happened at Versus Fighting, but I'm still doing good. And I think we've got Jim trying to dash punch, trying to EX dash punch his way into this call, because he's just cannot tell time. He's falling asleep all the time.
He's online right
is,
now.
Is he going to get in, or his arm? Has his armor been stuffed? No, he got through.
His armor has not been stuffed.
He got through and he landed the mid screen, so he's happy. He's in a good mood. That's cool. So let's just jump right in, guys. Versus Fighting was last weekend in Birmingham. Big tournament for the UK. Upsets, one might say. Super hype top eight. Really, really good tournament. Plenty of upsets throughout pools. I'm gonna start with 12 gauge, seeing you haven't been on the show before. What did you think about Versus Fighting? Just general impressions, your thoughts on the top eight, grand finals. I mean, it was a really hyped tournament and a good turnout for the UK. So, what were your takeaways from it?
Really and truly, the Versus Fighting events have always been a really, really well-run event, and this year, MK has been fucking huge. I'm seeing Madsen from across the waters coming over and taking all our money. I'm okay with that. I'm completely okay with that, because we went to Evo with this guy and this guy was an absolute ledge. So I'm thinking this was a fucking excellent tournament all the way. Although I think I spent more time playing Street Fighter V than I did actually participating in the tournament.
Fair enough. I mean, that was a pretty good bonus of that tournament.
Yes, it was.
Man, Madsen is cool though. It's impossible to hate that guy. He's too cool.
I don't think it is. I don't think it is possible to hate that guy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what did you think? What were your takeaways of the tournament? I know you're not necessarily in the best place about the game right now.
I thought the tournament was very well won. This was actually my very first Versus Fighting I've been to. And obviously, as with every kind of big tournament, there was like a few small issues, but nothing really to chat about. Everything was, as far as I can tell, smoothly run. Judges were good and always at hand. Quality of matches was really, really good. And I think it was a great showcase to the UK scene. And Justin and his team can be very proud for what they achieved for this year.
I second that. It was a really, really good tournament. This was my second Versus Fighting. I also went last year for Injustice. And, super well run. Really, really cool team. And a really good venue, too. I think the venue choice is always really good for Versus Fighting. Really, really good venue. Jim, what are your thoughts? And you're not allowed to start by downplaying Jax. That'll come
later.
See,
the problem with Jax is, right?
That'll come later on the show.
Nah, man, I thought the venue was nice. I always liked the fact that, because the cinema room last time was sick, and I thought, when I got in, I thought, oh, there's no, badass cinema room, how is this going to get done? Mm-hmm. And then, obviously, they switched that for the day two, and I thought, okay, that was sick. Mm-hmm. It was good of them to get Street Fighter V as well. They're the two little bonus points that they kept up. But, It was sick playing in a big game this year. So obviously we got to take part in the whole top eight business. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And overall we had more setups, because literally Injustice was just two setups last time.
Yeah.
No one got any casuals. It was just literally you're on, you're off. And then switch over to the one stream setup after for the top four, I think it was. So that was quite cool.
I agree. It was really cool being the main game, essentially. I mean, MK was the final game on Sunday. It was the final one. We had the final time slot. I think, although ironically enough, not the biggest crowd. I think Street Fighter, from what I saw of the main stage room, that had the biggest crowd.
I will say though, there was 92 signups for MK. There was not 92 people in that room at the end.
No, there was a lot of no-shows. I think that's the only real. That was my only real kind of disappointing aspect of the tournament, to be honest. When my pool started, I was talking to Zalaris about, you know, the actual pool starting and like getting everybody together. And the top half of like my area of the pool didn't turn up. There was about, I think, like maybe 8 or 9 people that just weren't there. Like, never mind there, but not playing, but just were not there, even at the venue, which really sucks because I know we had Justin on and he did kind of shed a lot of light, I thought, on like the amount of work and kind of logistics that go into organizing a tournament. It's a lot of work for those guys, and to sign up and like not bother turning up, I think is just really bad form, in my opinion. I think that sucks. If you don't want, if you know that you're not going to go, then just don't sign up. You know, don't sign up and pump up the numbers and then just sit on your ass for whatever reason and don't turn up on the day. That's really lazy. If I'm sure at least some of them had legit reasons, but you know, all of them having like a, you know, kind of life or death reason for not going, I don't know about that.
There could be a lot of dead gamers right now.
There could be, in which case I take that back. But
Also,
you
we can hear you playing Diablo in the background, Red. So quiet it down.
Oh shit.
That's true. It's usually gym where we get like the hitbox and keyboard BGM for
Yeah, that's true.
podcast. But
I'm sorry, man. This barbarian needs to fucking just get to level 90. What's there? What's there?
But let's talk more about the actual matches as well. There was a few upsets in this tournament throughout pools, and we'll get into top 8. We'll save top 8 till last. So what's some of your favorite matches you guys saw in pools? Let's start with Jim. I'll start with you. What were some of your favorite ones that you just got to watch?
Gab Dreadnought was my favorite.
Oh,
Because
so salty I didn't get to
because
see
he
that.
got in with the neutral jump roll like 3 times.
The Gab standard.
And I was laughing each time. Because I was watching for a good round and he didn't do it once. And then I thought, he's going to do it once, right? He's got to do it once. And as soon as I saw a neutral jump, it's way too far away when he's doing it. And then I saw his like land roll and he hit him. And then he did it like 2 more times to hit him again.
Much appreciation.
These shenanigans of a top 4 character.
You can tell on his face, man. He was not impressed. He was not impressed.
I bet Gabe was smiling, weren't you?
That was my favourite match from pools, just for that reason.
Cool. I bet you were smiling, weren't you, Gabe, on the inside?
To be honest, I didn't even realise I was doing it. It's just all subconscious. Just let my hands do the talking.
Fair dues, fair dues. Torgage, I know you mentioned that you played a lot of Street Fighter. Like, were you around for much of pools? Like, did you see a lot?
It was literally like, I think I saw one game. It was Apocalypse UK versus some Sonya. And
oh, sorry, loss.
Oh, man.
Did he
It was not a happy game to see.
Oh, what, did Apocalypse play 2 Sonyas? Because I think his first match was Smash, and he played Sonya.
Yeah, he played against a Sonya, and then he played against another Sonya, and then he was out.
Covert op.
I saw the second Sonya.
All right, okay. Yeah, that wouldn't have been Smash.
Damn it, man. I tried to give him some kind of little bit of inspirational help, but he did nothing. Damn it, man. Oh, no.
It sounds like you
Smash of knowledge.
Like the Sonya can do that to you, for sure. She is frustrating, you might say.
Yeah, she's
frustrating.
Frustrating against Sonya. Does what she wants whenever she wants. Like every character in this game. No, that's a lie. Like most characters in this game.
Yeah, to be honest, like, Sonya's one of those characters. I think going into a tournament, you've got to know Sonya. She's like she is annoying, but I think if you go in kind of cold against Sonya, you are probably going to get destroyed.
There's no probably about it.
Yeah, I mean, that's something. Because it's when I was talking to Smash, actually, before he played Apocalypse. Because I spoke to a couple of other people, and they mentioned that Apocalypse played Blood God. And I asked Smash, like, do you know the plus frames for Kotal Kahn? And he said no. And,
wait a minute, no. You see, you got this wrong? You got this wrong right here, you know. The very first thing you just said there. Kotal Kahn has no plus frames.
Yes, he does. Yeah, he does.
He has no plus frames.
One, dude, 114 cancelled. Air grab, that's plus.
It's not plus.
It is?
It's not plus at all. It's at the most goddamn, like, neutral. At
that,
the most.
That is plus. You can check you were down one. That is, I don't have like the frames on it, but that is plus. And like just the frames on his moves. And he said he didn't know. And I remember thinking, like, that's kind of key knowledge to know about Kotal Kahn. Like, you need to know that string. Like, you need to know that his back one stuff. Like, you need to know that too. Because, like, a lot of people kind of just stand there and let him do that when they shouldn't be.
I think
I think Sonya is the same. It's like, if you don't, like, Covert Ops Sonya, if you don't know her military stance options, you are in deep shit. Like, you have to know that stuff. It's like, it's super basic character knowledge.
Then flip the coin.
Yeah, but you know, she never has to commit, though. And I think that's something that a lot of Sonyas still do. They do military stance. Like, even if people block the first part of that string, they'll do another part of it. And it's like, that's where I think if you're playing against her, that should be a telltale sign. It's like, okay, well, she doesn't have to do that. So you should now be able to use what knowledge you have to blow that up. Like, a Sonya player never really has to do that and cancel it and be unsafe if they don't want to.
Uh-huh.
MIT showed that at Evo. Like, I don't think he ever did, like, a starter into military stance and do it into something that's full combo punishable on block. I don't think he ever did that once. And, like, that's a big thing about Sonya. If you're not doing that, then you need to start incorporating that into your game plan as Sonya. But yeah, I mean, she's an annoying character to fight as, for sure. Especially if you don't have, like, really good options after blocking a dive kick at, like, you know, the max range. If you can't get, like, a full punish on that, it really sucks.
Yeah, I retract my previous statement. It is plus.
Thank you. See you, man. I bring my lists. Bring my lists. I bring my lists. I know what's plus. Yeah, like, it's not like ridiculously plus, but it's like, it's how you use it, you know. It's like, it's how you use your plus frames. You have to be creative, like the way Madsen uses that stuff. That's why I always want him to play Bloodguard, because his Bloodguard is so hype to watch. Just him destroy people with Bloodguard, it's awesome.
Anytime you see him hit somebody and it takes off, you just see the red bar just getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and then you just find yourself panicking. I'm just like, what the fuck am I going to do now?
Yeah. It's like, I mean, you know, he's got, you know, you can knock him down, he's in trouble. Unless you're on a stage with interactables, so you can give him a reversal.
The only way knocking him down and putting him in trouble is going to be viable is if your character is a 50-50 character. If your character is a 50-50 character, then knocking him down is a completely viable strat. But if your character isn't a 50-50 character, knocking him down isn't going to do anything. All you're going to do is just apply a little bit of pressure to him.
Hmm.
Anybody who's true 50-50 will just destroy Kotal Kahn.
Yeah, anyone with decent frames destroys Kotal Kahn.
Yeah, that's true as well.
That too.
If you can keep him locked down, like in Bloodguard at least, like if you can keep him like really locked down and just deny him like any aspect of his
game. It's not at the point where people are punishing his damn 4 yet with stuff, so
yeah, it is minus 10
his forward 2 as well, even though exactly. He can low profile out of forward 2. Like, a lot of Kotals will do forward 2 and hit a button, and like that you
it's minus 10 you can punish it with dash punch.
Yeah, you got a stand block.
Yeah, you need a move that, like, there are certain moves that cannot punish you though, because he can just down one you out of it, which is really annoying. And
it's a big pet peeve
of mine of the game that is actually possible. If something's minus 10, like Scorpion for example, if he does forward 2 and I block it standing, my standing 1's 9 frames, I can do standing 1, he can just down 1 it and low crush the high, like even though he's minus 10. That, like, I hate that shit.
You know, one thing I hate in this game is low profiling moves, because not every character has them. And that's going to hurt a lot of characters.
Yeah, the characters that can do that are really good. But you drifted off topic a bit. Let's get back to pools. Gabe, what was one of your favourite matches in pools?
not meaning to sound super egotistical, but me versus Dread Knight was one of my favorites.
Fair enough. That's fine.
Only because it's definitely one of the very few matches that I felt that I've played or shown my most cleanest display as Melina, ignoring the gap standard specials of entry jump roll.
Hey man, that's legit. Don't anyone.
Legit strategy, yeah.
So it's a bait. It's a baiting strategy.
You hit him with all three. It's legit.
So really, you have to hit it
all.
Well,
yeah, that's a good point. Yeah.
Yeah.
True. I did enjoy. I didn't like the outcome, but I did enjoy Endeavormore versus Vegito.
That was good. That was going to be
really
of
good. Quan Chi versus Sonya, but it was unfortunate for Endeavormore not being able to take the set, which he did. Who else did I see? Justin versus Cosmos was pretty good. Jackie versus Cassie.
I didn't see that one.
Yeah, it was quite late. It was just before. I think that was just before top 16. Mm-hmm. Thinking about it. But yeah, it was a close set. It was unfortunate for Justin not being able to take it, but Cassie is Cassie. Mm. And Jackie is Jackie.
Is that horrible?
What is this problem with Jackie that everybody's talking about?
We can get into that later. We can have a bonus segment because I do want to talk about Jackie a little bit. I feel my girl is getting some. She's getting trash talked a lot, and I'm not having it. So we'll get into that later. We'll follow that up with. We'll follow that after Jax because I know you guys want to talk about Jax.
Oh, yeah, father daughter segment.
Yeah, exactly. Jim, what about you? What are some of your favorite matches you got to see in pools?
I said gaps, didn't I? I only watched a couple of others. I watched Swizzer versus Zigzag, and that was a bit shit for Swizzer because he was missing a lot of punishes and stuff.
Did Zigzag play Predator? So we played him. We got a chance to play him in the hotel casuals, and he mentioned that his main's actually Predator, but he wasn't unlocked on.
He played Predator.
What variation?
He's Q10.
Okay.
Is he one of those scumbag predators that are just like, I'll stay one side and throw everything at you?
Well, no, he was waking up a bit, a lot with the stab. Swizzer punished twice, but then he didn't punish all the other times. And he was fully committing as well. He was doing 1-1 ice ball.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't get it half the time, and then he got punished for it. So it was a bit lame.
Okay.
But other than that, I don't think there's many matches and pools I watched. Because I was waiting for Street Fighter for ages, weren't I? Because I was doing the whole PS4 thing.
Yeah.
So I was over there for ages.
Oh, man.
There was one pools match that I would have liked to see, and it was Ixie versus Xeon.
I don't know what happened there.
Especially if you saw their match in Top 8, because that was pretty, that was all him. And yet, he was actually the one that put him in losers. So, he did seem fairly unfamiliar with Inferno, though. I know Madzin was playing him. Madzin, shout out to Madzin. But he was saying, how are you losing to the shit? with Inferno Scorpion. He was like, this is shit! How did he beat you? I went over and told him some stuff about Inferno. I was like, yeah, this is all a complete bill. You don't have to respect this. I think he didn't know that 2-1-4 into high minion is Cassie can actually just standing one that she doesn't have to she doesn't even have to block the overhead minion. She can just completely interrupt it clean. He can use EX flip kick as well, and that seemed to help him quite a bit in the matchup. I'm trying to think of the other matches in pools. I'm trying to remember mine. Mine were, my pool matches, none of them were, really... My match against Mustard was really good. I was kind of disappointed that wasn't streamed. I thought that was a really tense matchup. He played Bone Shaper, Hellfire Scorpion. And I actually felt Scorpion does pretty well against Bone Shaper. I think Bone Shaper, there's a couple of things. I think if you have a really fast low poke, I think you can kind of regulate Bone Shaper a little bit better than other characters. If you don't have, a six-frame low, he can kind of go to town on you with his basic pressure. If you've got a six-frame poke, he has to use meter to really get anything on you, and then he's used a bar, and if he doesn't get anything, he's used a bar for, 4% chip. So it's not that big of a deal. So shout-outs to Scorpion. Shout-outs to Scorpion's down one, six-frame down one. Let's talk about top 8, because I think top 8 is the juice. Top 8 is the juicy of this tournament. 12 gauge, what did you think? Top Favorite match? Let's just go. Favorite match, top eight.
Favorite match, Madsen Denim. Madsen, F0xy Grampa.
Grand Finals?
Yeah, Grand Finals was my favorite match. Like, nothing... Oh, yeah. And Skeleton Realm being opened up for Ajaxi.
That was good. That was tight.
Godlike.
Theatrics, man. I love theatrics. More people need that. Like, when Justin gets his fatality on stage, he always does Jackie's fatality. Like, catch up with the Skeleton Realm.
Oh, that was godlike. That was godlike. Like, if Madsen ever played Blood God, you'd have seen some theatrics.
I wanted it. I mentioned that on commentary after, I think that was in the first set when he took a break. And I mentioned it to Reese. I was like, I'm hoping to see Blood God. I want to see him go Blood God. But his Blood God's just too hype. Jim, what about you? Favorite match, top eight?
Ooh, It's gonna have to be like F0xy and Madsen. It's just gonna have to be, isn't it? Because it was like
the amount of misses, the amount of reads that was done there.
Yeah, it was sick.
Absolutely amazing.
It was sick, wasn't it?
Yeah, like Madsen's play. I mean, it speaks for itself. It was phenomenal.
I will say though, him versus Mustard was really good as well. Because like he was going over some stuff versus Bone Shaper like in the top 16 like after I qualified for top 8, and like while the rest of the matches was going on, we was just like going over Bone Shaper, and he did do some stuff that I showed him in the matchup. Mm-hmm. Like he waited for the Hell Sparks, because you can, if you stand correctly in a space, you can jump over Hell Sparks, because you jump as you see this first one come out, you jump. The first one, like, only goes up to, like, a Vecinox, like, head and explodes. And if you've jumped as you've seen it come out, that'll explode and the second one won't catch you, and he did it. And he took him all the way to the corner from it. So that was pretty sick.
Nice.
Like, I saw it and applied it within, like, no games, just practice.
Yeah, that's a really good thing. That's like a really strong mark of a player too, if you can do that. Like, if you don't need matchup experience to incorporate like quite specific matchup tech, that's a really good thing to have. Alright, Gabe, what about you? Are you gonna go? You gonna go with the norm, Madsen F0xy, or do you have?
I think you would have to. Madsen F0xy Grand Finals was pretty great, but also prefaced from the fact that when they met in Winners Finals,
F0xy 3-0'd him.
Yeah, he had Madsen's number essentially. And just to do that kind of turnaround and essentially, was it six straight games? Madsen won?
Six.
Yeah, six straight. That kind of turnaround on a player like F0xy.
Reminds you of the Invitational, doesn't it?
Yeah, just a little. So that, you know, combined with the matches that they had, because none of the matches also was like free for Madsen. It wasn't really like dominant. I mean, it was dominant, but the end result didn't tell the story of how the matches played out.
That's true, yeah. Sometimes that can be the case when you have, like, if you get 3-0'd, you can have, like, three super close games, but 3-0 makes it look kind of like a whitewash. And it's like, well, that's not really how it went down, but, you know, the score can reflect that.
And he did it with Sub-Zero as well.
Yeah, Sub-Zero. I mean, Sub-Zero's good. I mean, I think this showed it, you know? Like, I mean, Madsen is a phenomenal player.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, you know, he really did kind of, I mean, that was, you know, a tutorial on how to play Sub-Zero. Like, that was really, really good. It was super entertaining to watch. So, that was going to be my pick as well. I did also like Ketchup and Madsen too. I thought that was a really good set. That was, like, really good kind of, like, just... It felt like kind of wrestling with the corner in that matchup.
True.
It was like, every single time one of them got cornered, it was like, right, I need to get out. I need to get out of the corner, otherwise I'm going to die.
Yeah, both of them has no fucking options. It was real good to see. Especially with both of those characters against each other. Sub-Zero ain't got shit against Quan-Chi. Quan-Chi ain't got shit against Sub-Zero. Especially when they're in the corner. It was stupid, but fun.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So anything else you guys want to mention with Versus Fighting, or do you want to move on to the main event?
I guess it would be nice to quickly ask how everyone felt performance-wise in the tournament.
Yeah, I'm never happy.
Yeah, I was happy. I was happy up until the point I was eliminated, because I lost to my first match was not that difficult, but like he just kind of did some weird stuff with Kong Lao, like didn't really hit confirm, like played very very unsafe. So if you like, that's exactly how I want you to play when I play Scorpion, because then I get to just punish you. Then, like, if you play like that, I get to use the best aspect of Scorpion all the time, his punishment. I just get to punish you all day. So, you know, don't play like that against Scorpion. The second match was Mustard. That was super close. I did what is becoming, like, my trademark of dropping the game-winning EX teleport combo. because EX teleport, jump three, teleport is... Man, you guys don't know how hard that combo is, man.
So one frame links.
Are we talking about hard combos here?
It's such a hard combo, man. I've got to do jump three, back, down, back three. God, it's so hard. Yeah, like, dropping that combo, I was not happy. And then, like, just played again, super, super close. Like, it was 2-0, but again, like, last round, last amount of health. It was a super close game. And I was kind of happy about that match, because I thought, you know, he's one of our best, and... I was kind of down on Scorpion a little bit before this tournament, and I felt like I played my best in that matchup, and I thought, okay, well, I played my best, and I almost beat one of the best, so how bad can Scorpion be? Like, I just need to focus on getting better. I just need to focus on improving my play. Second match was the Jason player. Again, like, kind of unfamiliar with the game, so, you know, not really that big of a deal. Last match was Margin. He played Ermac, and, like, Foxy was very quick to tell me what I didn't do, and he was absolutely right. So, again, just need to focus on getting better. And really taking note of what people do in every situation. That was, like, Foxy's big tip after I lost. And I was like, yeah, I know. Like,
Wait a minute. You actually got a useful tip from Foxy?
Yeah.
Foxy's, like, his tournament dad.
Yeah, like, every time, like, I, like, play, like, Foxy is, he's around, he's in the vicinity. And, like, I can't believe it. Right, you need to do this. It's like, you're not doing this, you need to do this. Like, it's like, yeah, I know.
Like, you want to tell you something? I asked Foxy something yesterday, you weren't even there. I asked Foxy something yesterday about me playing against his Kong Lao. He was playing Buzzsaw. We're playing a couple games. And I was like, what the fuck am I doing wrong? And he was like, get wrecked.
Well, to be fair, like, you know, we get that from Foxy as well, like, when we're playing online, like, you know. Like, but, you know, in tournament, like, you know, if you ask him, like, you know, for pointers, like, he usually always says, like, yeah, you know, you, like, he did this, like, you didn't really pick up on that. And I mean, he's right, like, you know, pretty much all the time. So, yeah, like, if someone like that is, you know, trying to give you advice, like, you know, try and take it on, you know, learn from this, one might say.
No, I refuse.
Get your Foxy strategy guide out. Rule number one, remember, guys, don't get hit. Rule number two, God. See rule
that strategy. That strategy.
That's what the strategy guide is. So yeah, that kind of covers my tournament experience, really. I was happy with it, but, like, unhappy with it in some aspects. So, what do you think, Gabe? How do you feel about this tournament?
I mean, grand scheme of things, I did quite well, but I was disappointed by my end result, because I really wanted to get top 16 at the very, very lowest, and ended up coming 17th as a bit of a heartbreaker. I'm trying to think. First match was OD Fire, who played Kung Jin. That was a bit of a messy match, but to be fair, pulled out through nicely.
Yeah, I remember watching that, and it got me really frustrated, because I know you can't punish his launches, and it's like, why can't Melina punish that?
That
must
especially
be
when she's so fast.
Like, it must be a really frustrating part of the matchup to not be able to punish those moves.
It is. Just have to deal with it. Second match was against Ketchup, which I actually thought might have been put on stream, but never mind. And with that, I got the first game. Made him a little bit salty. Which
yes.
Is nice.
Yes.
Yes. But he got the next two when he adapted quite well. But also, I feel the next two games I played a bit too conservative. Because of the first game, I was making quite a few ballsy reads.
Yeah, you should just
carry on that trend. But I just took my foot off the gas a little bit and paid the price. But it made me feel confident and good for the rest of the tournament, knowing because I was in a bit of a weird place where I wasn't really sure how I stand skill-wise and not really 100% into my character at the time. But then with that performance, I was like, well, I just went toe-to-toe with someone who went fifth at Evo and I didn't actually do too badly.
Good.
So, and then after that was Dread Knight, the infamous Dread Knight match. Which went well.
I really wanted to watch that. I saw, I think, the first round start and I had to play my match.
That's unfortunate.
I did want to watch that.
But yeah, that was pretty good. Anti-jump rolls. Anti-aired him literally every single time.
Yeah, the anti-air's on point.
I've noticed you've gotten like significantly better at that over the past month.
Yeah, it's quite an important thing to deal with now.
It's huge. Like, if you can take away people's jumping game. You played, I'm assuming you just played Thunder God Raiden both times, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
After that, I played a Kung Lao, which... bit of a wrong attitude to have, but when I sat down and hit Kung Lao, I was like, I'll play Foxy, this should be fine.
Was it fine?
It was, actually, funny enough.
That is the general consensus.
It's fine until they start throwing out the unsafe overhead, the unsafe low that you've not seen in the past 500 games, and you're like, what the hell is this?
That is true. But it's just that when you play someone that is like,
it's just weird.
The best in that character, everyone else, you just, when you sit down and you find someone else plays that same character, you just think they're not going to be as good as this person. So as long as I know what to look out for, I should be fine. And it kind of was. Mm-hmm. And final match that I lost to was against Reefer. I technically threw away the first game in the character select screen by choosing the wrong variation. Because I went piercing, but with piercing, Ford 1-2 has a issue against Aaron Black, and I didn't check my phone before the match to see whether I should have gone with piercing or not. Because I have a list of essentially every character where Ford 1-2 has an issue with in piercing, and Aaron Black is one of those, but I didn't check. So
you lost to your own.
Yeah, I lost to me neglecting my own notes. So it serves me right. Once I switched to Ravenous, I pulled the game back and it was 1-1. And then got to the final round of the final game. And he did, whether on purpose or not, he was seemed to have been cutting his combos short or dropping his combos into 50-50s. And I kept guessing wrong. Now, he was only taking like 10 to 15% at a time. But once you do it like 3 or 4 times, that adds up quite a bit.
He did that to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, and did it once, though.
Fair enough. And so yeah, I ended up losing that. And I was more frustrated for myself for losing that match. And I would have played Jim at top 16 on stream. Yeah. I would have been sick. But such is life.
Would Jim have got the gap standard? Would he have got would he have got neutral jump roll?
I can't promise
that. It would have been a very boring game of Bone Shaper Shinnok. Just waiting for the teleport.
Scumbag. Jim, what do you think about your tournament experience? How you played?
Played shit with Jax, played okay with Bone Shaper.
Nah, man, you should have stuck with Jax. The reason you didn't win is because you didn't play Jax all the time.
The thing is with Jax, on like anything that isn't my own monitor, is it's the biggest pain in the ass ever.
The stream setup was good, though. The match I played on stream, I thought was all right.
I only need a few frames off though, because like a lot of the run cancels, I'm going off muscle memory off my own monitor, because I need you need to basically, otherwise you're never gonna get them. And I'd adjust well to like the slightest bit, and the monitors on the stream are always a bit different because they're obviously like having to put it through a lot of different things.
Yeah.
And like, that's why that first match with that ranks was so horrible. But I have to say thanks for him to doing that overhead. that's probably got 100 frames of recovery on my wake up while I delayed, which was nice of him. But yeah, like, other than that, I played a bit better in some of the other poor matches, but honestly, I was playing like crap the whole day. Came in with bone shaper the next day, though, and I was fine.
Uh-huh. Are you going to swap to bone shaper, or are you actually going to make the switch?
In tournament now, I'll play bone shaper and hunter predator.
Fair enough.
Fair enough.
Because they're both equally 10 times as more bullshit than jacks.
And bullshit as well. What if they get normalized and jacks stays the same?
I'll probably still switch because Jax doesn't play the same as like the way, because the way I've been like thinking of it is like Bone Trapper plays like Green Lantern, right? He just trip guards you to death, shoots shit at you, and then you like can't jump, and you're like, well, what can I do? And that's like Bone Trapper perfectly, except this time he has a plus on block minigun, so I just get to run in and kick you again. Like, that's the only difference.
That's true.
So
yeah.
It's like, imagine if Green Lantern's minigun was like plus 14, I got to run in and lower you again.
Yeah, that's, you'd be
like,
that's a good
point. Yeah, that's the difference. And like, Hunter's kind of like Martian in a way, in which I can just throw crap at you, then run in and press buttons.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I see that. 12 gauge, what about you?
I'm never happy with any performance that I've done. It's just, I lost against two guys that, I just lost to myself, really.
Who did you play? Do you remember?
I played, who the fuck did I play?
I don't even remember. Yeah, I know you lost to the other Dread.
Yeah, oh yeah, I lost to Dread.
Yeah, he lost to Dread.
What characters did you lose to? Like, who did they use?
I know Kotal Kahn. I lost to Kotal Kahn, and I lost to Kitana? I think it's a Kitana. I don't remember.
Oh, did you lose to Demonics, then?
Oh, yeah.
Demonics.
Yeah, I think, yeah, that's it. Demonics. Demonics and Dread. That's who I lost to.
I can't believe you lost your own name.
What can I say, man? There can only be one Dread.
Yeah.
Any takeaways, though, 12 gauge, or just you're gonna?
No takeaway. I need to be better.
Well, that's a takeaway.
Sometimes that is the only takeaway, and it does suck. If like that's annoying. It's like you know, if you
pick a top tier.
Like, I just need to be better.
Should pick a top tier.
Yeah.
No,
I'm playing my character. I'm sticking.
Yeah, I'm not doing top tier.
Like, I've definitely picked up other characters in the past, like, month. And I think that actually really helps. I think picking up other characters really helps. I think it helps, like, kind of keeping them fresh.
So I need to get Bone Shaper engraved on my middle now. There's a thank you. Thank you. For being there when I needed him the most.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, it's tournament, so... I really had it off of mine when I sat down in my first match to play Venomous Devorah. But I thought, nope, I'm going to stick with my boy. And I won. Won with him. I won with my boy. But yeah, Venomous Devorah is so cool, man. I love that.
So you saw the Jax versus Bone Shaper matchup.
I saw you drop combos.
Nah, that's not the important part.
I was annoyed at that. I was so happy when you picked Jax. I was like pumping you up on comments like, yes, he's picked Jax, yes!
I did better with Hunter Predator. With
First thing
at
he
that
does,
point.
Like, forward three, it's like, yes! And he drops the combo. No!
Yeah, it's inconsistent, that combo. I did the hard one, which is inconsistent, which is why I normally don't do it.
Yeah, that was heartbreaking for me.
Because it's really inconsistent. Like, the timing of it, if for some reason... Jax hits him too far away, you can't get the actual four combo anyway. So you have to do a different combo, which involves you run cancelling rather than not run cancelling. And if you don't recognise that you need to run cancel, you just whiff the 4-2-1 and get like 20%. Not even 20%, like 70.
That sucks.
For your unsafe knee.
Anything else you guys want to talk about versus fighting, or do you want to move on?
Oh, I think we can move on.
The food. The food. Oh my god. Oh, that waitress was godlike.
Shoutouts to, was it Homemade Burger Company?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, true.
No, Homemade or Handmade, whichever Homemade, it was.
I think it was Handmade.
Handmade Burger Company, yeah.
That food was godlike, and that waitress was fucking nice as fuck. Shout out.
Yeah. Like, when we went
Shoutouts to Milkshake bringing the boys to the yard.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, me and Gabe actually went there twice in one day. That was our second visit.
Oh,
man, that place was godlike. That really was. It was seriously, seriously
awesome. Nice stuff.
Cool. So let's move on. Let's talk about Jax, seeing as we've got two Jax players on the show. Well, we have one Jax player, and we have one, you know, Jax player that also plays Bone Shaper Shinnok, because he's a scumbag.
But yeah, Jim has been recognized as a Jax player, but he's not a Jax player at heart. Jim is what you call an opportunist.
He's an opportunist Jax player.
Jim is an opportunist.
I'll pave the way for that down one plasma tech that you never used.
Yeah, yeah.
Now it's expired, and now I see you using it, and now you want to use it.
It was only fucking good because people were stupid at the start of this game. That's the only reason.
Exactly. It expired. But I see you doing down one plasma and down three plasma. But you're trying to cash in your tokens that I gave you, and they've all gone.
No,
they ain't worth anything anymore.
This is just
my tokens are still valid. My tokens were valid from the fucking day the game came out. I just never used them because I was busy future-proofing my tokens. My tokens are still going to be useful in the future because people are going to be stupid in the future, like always.
No, because you're still with Jax. I have gone up 10 places on the tier list.
Man, so is that saying Jax isn't even top 10?
No, Jax is 10th, but Bone Shaper's number one.
Then that's 9 places. Opinion.
Bone Shaper number one in the game.
In my opinion, because he has no bad matchups.
Okay, so let's talk about Jax.
Just don't say that character can have bad matchups.
Let's get right to the juicy. Is Jax top 10? Is he a top 10 character?
On 10th, but you could argue with like other characters. So it's around 10, though.
Okay. 12 gauge, you agree with that? Is he top 10?
Definitely.
I have no knowledge as to where Jax is in the tier list. All I know is that he's got problems with the top characters. That's all I know.
Okay, probably a better way to ask the question then. Is Jax a tournament viable character?
Yes.
Could somebody feasibly win a tournament with 100% Jax?
Yes, that's possible.
You have to work really hard though.
Mm-hmm. But it's possible.
Like really hard, just like 10 times harder. Yeah, pretty much.
It's like fucking people who have characters that have guaranteed shit. They ain't gotta work that hard because if you have like 5% chip, and then you have meter, you're like, oh, you know what? I'm just gonna do this string into this meter burn whatever or non meter burn whatever, or I'm gonna run cancel this and I'm gonna be guaranteed to fucking get this button. This button is guaranteed. They can't stop that. And because that button is guaranteed, now they have so many more options because your opponent, unless your opponent is fucking stupid and knows nothing, they're just gonna be like, oh shit, this is guaranteed. You know what? I might as well mash out, see if anything happens. But they do the guaranteed shit. And guess what? You get hit for mashing out, and you're fucked up.
Yeah, that's true. I know when the game came out, I think Jax kind of had some of the most obvious like pressure in how it worked. And since the game's evolved, I do play against Jim's Jax, even though it is still annoying, but man, it's like a fucking honeymoon compared to fighting Kung Lao.
Yeah.
It's like Jax's pressure. It's like, yeah, this is good, but I mean, like there's far better pressure in the game than that. So I think that's like Jax can give you some perspective on like how good, you know, some characters' pressure really is. It's like, you know, if you make the right read, Jax doesn't really have anything guaranteed really outside the corner. Whereas
nothing is guaranteed.
Like, not guaranteed. I mean outside.
In terms of armor, he has a bunch of frame traps, but it's being
it's minimal at best.
Yeah.
The thing is. That I always say, it's like, with Jax, that's why I hate playing him on, like, different monitors and why I don't do as well. Outside of, like, his dodgy execution barrier as well. Like, say if I do 1-1 and I think you're going to press the button right, I'll down 3 or down 1. Now, depending on your poke, the down 3 is just like a you've got crap poke things. Like, against Kouncil, I'm going to down 3 because it's plus two, then, well, I'll explain. This is kind of my point. If I did 1-1 against Quan Chi as an 8, well, I don't think as an 8-frame poke, does it's a 9-frame.
Quan Chi.
Yeah.
I'll check.
But like, it's, he has an 8-frame stand 2, but I think his down 3 is 9 frames and stuff like that. But I don't know. But like, say against anyone else, I'll do 1-1 and I'll do down 1, because I'm a down 1, 7 frames and a plus 2. So, a lot of the time, it's in like, a lot of time people have a 7 frame 1, so I have a 2 frame link to frame trap, yeah, which ain't too bad. So I hit the down 1. Then I have a choice. I'm plus 15 and I have a 14 frame low. So technically, if I am frame perfect, I should be able to scare you enough with this low that I am guaranteed to get every time to then hit you with some overheads. But we all know it doesn't work like that, don't we? Because you have to be frame perfect, and you get armored, and you get backdashed, and you get hit.
Could one not argue that's just a part of playing Jax, though?
That's what I'm saying. But that's what I'm saying. He can win. He can win a tournament. But, like, this is what he has to deal with in a on a hit basis. Like, his down 4 is plus... His down 4 is plus 25. You have to do a small run cancel and do a 13-frame normal. All in all, it adds up to about, like, 20-something frames. If you don't get it, you get kicked. Or you get backdashed. Or you get some other dumb crap.
Could you not make the point that, like, I mean, there are other characters in the history of, like, the NRS games that have things that are once deemed, oh, you know, people will never get this.
But then it's just his whole... It seems, like... It's a lot of his game plans, like it. A lot of his game.
Yeah, I'm not disagreeing. Like Jax is one of the harder characters to use in
that's
the game.
That's it. That's why I agree he can win a tournament. But that's I'll explain his other problems in a second from like his other stuff. But with some of which they could like address. But at the like even without the problems, he's just a very hard character to play.
Yeah.
Like he can win.
What do you think?
Like if you played on point, every damn one you hit, and that. Like,
you can get something from it.
You could get a 50-50.
Yeah.
But obviously, like, that's hard to, like, enforce in tournament.
It is, but he does
on a street, on a monitor you're not used to, right? It's not like you meet a burner move and you're just 14.
What do you think about
it? I think he has the tools, but everybody has much more tools than him.
I think at the moment as well, he does struggle against the top tiers, like I think he said.
Yeah, I think like this game, kind of like Injustice, is at least at this point in the game's life, is somewhat coloured by that. You can have a character that does really well, but if you struggle against, you know, the real kind of common tournament characters, you are in for kind of a rough time.
Like outside of that, the thing is, he struggles against some weird characters as well, like A-list Johnny Cage. I hate that matchup so much.
Yeah, but, and Liu Kang. A-list Johnny Cage is, like, I mean, is he not top tier?
I think he has. I think he's really good.
I don't mean that he's not. A-list like, Johnny
think
Cage
he's really
is
good.
Really, really.
And good. Like, he's not in the characters I'll put above Jax. So if you want to make him 11 for JEB, that's fine by me. But but now, nah, but
let's
like
not get crazy here. Let's not get.
But now,
nah,
like,
let's
like,
bring
against,
our
like,
lists
against some other. But the thing is, Jax struggles against some other characters, but against characters that he can get in on not too bad, then he can be stupid. But against the top tiers at the moment, I think he struggles.
Yeah.
I think you have to play really well against the current top tiers.
Gabe, what do you think about him from a Molina perspective? What do you feel about Jax?
Well, I play a shitter, so anyone that's got good stuff is miles and miles well good.
You play top 4, according to some people.
Yeah, fuck that shit.
Or top 1, according to some people. I
just roll.
Believe it when you text me that. I was like, what the fuck?
but yeah, I think Jax is a really good character. As Jim and 12 Gage said, he does have some great tools, but I guess compared to the people that have got guaranteed pressure or brain dead kind of pressure, he definitely seems more fair. So maybe he can say he's a slightly unfair character in a very, very unfair game.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it, actually.
Or he's a very fair character in an extremely unfair game.
I wouldn't say he's fair.
Oh, he is fair.
No, he's not.
What's unfair about
it? Let's get into this. What do you think's unfair, Gabe?
What I think's unfair? Well, anyone that can do any kind of staggering pressure is essentially an unfair character.
That means everybody in this game is unfair.
Not everybody's got staggered pressure on their strings. Come on.
Yeah.
Like, not everybody's got that.
Which character doesn't recover fast enough to have staggered pressure?
Scorpion.
Melina.
If you have anything that recovers in under 12 frames, you can stagger that.
Yeah, so Scorpion, that doesn't change. That doesn't change that at all.
That recovers in under 12 frames. Shit.
He has not got that at all. Like, that's something, that's one thing that annoys me when I see Scorpions get away with that. Or they'll do it like 2-1 into 2-1. It's like, oh god, that's not a thing. Like, that's like not even nearly a thing. But yeah, I mean, like, not every character has that. Like, and Jax hasn't got the best of it, but he has still got it. Like, you know, he's like forward 2-1 being neutral on block. It's, that's good. That's important. That's an important part.
I think that's plus now. I don't know what the frame date is. I think it's so plus.
All right. Well, even if it's neutral, sure. I mean, even more so. Like, that's a really, like, that's a really good tool to have. So, what else do you think is unfair, Gabe?
I mean, that's just the main key point. Oh, maybe a projectile that's plus 7. Even though it's a high, but that's a bit stupid.
It is, but like 30 frames, though.
You can't get anything from that projectile.
No.
If you're blocking standing from mid-screen, then that's kind of stupid. You have nothing to block standing.
I agree with that, but I do agree with Gabe that, like, just looking at that, like, a plus 7 projectile.
Yeah, but when you, like, compare it to, like, the speed...
Yeah, people, but I mean, don't get hit by that. People don't block that anymore. That, you know, that does lead back into his pressure.
Yeah, but
like,
nah, people don't block that anymore. People kill you for that now. That time is gone. I cashed in all those plasma tokens. Dread
plasma chips.
None. Dread still has a pile, and he's trying to cash him in.
My pile is useless now. My pile of plasma tokens is useless. I'm slowly using my pile of plasma tokens.
He's selling them on eBay. Like, it's like having
old money. It's literally got them on eBay, and occasionally one gets bought.
He's got some, like, shillings, and it's like, nah, bro, these aren't valid anymore, sorry.
Meanwhile, me spending all mine, I just bought Bone Shaper Shinnok. So, like, that's why I'm playing Bone Shaper. Spending all my plasma.
Anything else? Gabe?
I think that is the main... Those are the main key points.
Yeah.
Okay. But I might be speaking through, you know, coloured eyes, because... My character essentially doesn't have really pressure, apart from maybe 2 strings. But even that, that's still super negative, and it's the opponent's turn afterwards.
Oh yeah, let's talk about opponent's turns. When do you get a turn against any other top tier? When do you actually get your turn? Tell me, and anybody who understands that shit, when is it your turn to do anything?
I mean, it depends on the character. Like, I mean, like, Bone Shaper Shinnok is a good example of that. Like, when his main, like, meterless string, forward 4-1 down 2, is it, Jim?
Yeah.
Forward 4-1 down 2 into, you know, pull out my 9 move. That's, like, what, minus 3?
Minus 4, but minus 4.
Minus 4, yeah. And that's, it's a key part in Shinnok and why he's so good against those characters. If you don't have a 6-frame poke, that is a really annoying string sequence to have to deal with, because like it's never really your turn. But if you do have a 6-frame poke, like I thought that when playing Mustard, I knew that I was likely going to play him, so I did spend a couple of hours in training mode before I set out the night before, really looking into that. And every single time he did that string, like, I was like, right, I can down 1, I can down 4, and you have to respect that. You cannot just...
Exactly.
You cannot do that on Scorpion. You can't just be like, hold this string, you can't do shit. So, I mean, like, Jax has a 6-frame down 1.
7. So, I
mean, is it 6? Oh, is it 7?
7, yeah.
Yep.
Okay. 6 frames down 1.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, so, I mean, he's got a 7-frame down 1. Like, you know, he can answer to that. So, it's just some characters... can't answer to it. And Melina against Bone Shaper Shinnok, that, I mean, Gabe, how do you feel playing
it's
that?
Not fun, put it that way.
Yeah, it's like, you know, he does that and it's like, okay, yeah, I've got to kind of put my arse on the line just to get out of meterless pressure.
The thing that's so good with that pressure is I want you to poke, because I get 4% chip every time, right? So if I do that string on block and then you poke, you're negative. So then I'll come in and do it again.
Uh-huh.
and then
yeah, but that's the mind game of the pressure though.
But the reason that pressure is so good is because every time you go, he's gonna do it again, or he's gonna do something else, and then you press a button, and it's like you're eating 4% for pressing a button.
Yeah, but I mean, you have to establish a mind game after that.
That's what makes the pressure good.
You know?
Yeah, that's what, like, that pressure's just, like, he has his mix-ups, like, mostly in the corner with Bounce Trap, because the link's really hard in the mid-screen. But, like, the thing is, it builds him a bunch of meter as well. Like, that's how the character's really easy. He plays himself. It's literally, you look out for a poke, or you bait a poke. If not, you keep chipping him out. And then when you have the meter, you can either confirm or spend the meter to get an extra, like, X amount of chip, like another 2%, and then throw them, so it's like 15% a bar. Like, guaranteed, that is, because nobody's pressing a button, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can spend a bar for 15% every time.
Let's talk about Jax's problems.
Right, you want the problems?
I've said that. Yeah, I want legit problems. I don't want first world problems. I want legit problems.
I probably need to start playing to get this down. I don't want to hear.
Oh, this string is plus. Get out of here. Like, if anything like that. Oh, this is neutral. No, I want to hear real problems of the character.
All right, first one.
Just bear that in mind.
First one, the big one that's really annoying. It's like the most annoying problem this character has is the old head dash punch combos. And I say annoying because if you've ever tried them on a female, anything that isn't heavy weapons where you've cancelled it to 1-2, a specific string, you go, fuck this. I am never doing this. It's pointless. I mean, Dredd still tries, and then we see him a bunch.
Okay. Now, as Jim has just said, one main problem with Jax against everybody in this game is consistency.
Yeah.
He has what I could say is arguably one of the best set of normals in the game. He has really fucking nice damage, but we're not comparing it to anything meterless. We're just comparing metered damage here. Mm-hmm. He has real good damage, but the consistency of his damage is absolutely poor. In the corner, everybody knows that you can't do certain combos against certain characters, right? But in the corner, he has everything in the corner. And this is bringing me back to MK9, where mid-screen he had shit all, but in the corner he had everything. You were like, when you go to the corner, it's like he had Christmas. There's like 10 different, you had Christmas from 10 different fucking nations, 10 different religions, 10 different cultures, all that Christmas, all bundled into one. Every time you hit somebody, there was just that little brief joy that you're like, I worked for this. This is mine. This is mine. But in mid-screen, like, yeah, he has overhead and a low. That's real good. He can't get shit off the overhead against most characters, and he can't get shit off the low against most characters.
Okay, let's talk about this. Let's talk about this for a second. The inconsistencies is true, but, like, what is the difference between, like, you know, I want to get max damage, and what's the difference between, like, okay, I'm going to do this because I know this works all the time? Like, what kind of difference are you talking
about? You're talking about, is it, like, 15%? Because if you get an overhead and you say you do run forward 4-2-1-1-1, 4-2-1-2, if you've carried to the corner, you get an extra string, so you get 1-2-4. That equals about 43%.
No, you get 47 in pumped up. You get 47% in pumped up.
What's that? And the low?
Off back two. Off back two, you get 47. You get 47% in pumped up. And
if you did run forward like 4-3 knee, you get like 30. You get 29.
Right, so this is 40. So we're comparing a 47% mid-screen one-bar combo that carries you to the corner while playing as Jax, a character that wants you.
Yeah, you won't hit that against a female. You're hit like once every 20 times.
Okay.
That doesn't work against female.
That's consistent.
No.
No.
It's not consistent. Not unless you're in heavy weapons. Because you just cancel into 1-2.
So it's consistent in heavy weapons then?
Yeah, because you're having to cancel. Because you cancel, you do another string. It reduces the damage to around 36.
Okay, so So you get 36%.
Yeah.
For something
that's
that
it. That's if you hit all the links
and
that's,
carries
well,
you to the combo and carries you to the corner, basically.
Yes.
Yeah, but that means he's like. We're talking about problems, right? So now I have to pick heavy weapons because...
We're talking about real problems, remember?
Yeah, so...
real problems.
So every time I pick Pumped Up and Wrestler, you just have to think, fuck it, his overhead's worth 30%. And...
That's 30%!
For a meter...
You don't get hit by 30%!
30%!
Oh, fucking hell, bro. 30%
for a meter, right? 30% for a meter that you can then tech roll because you're doing a dash punch, which is not a hard knockdown. And he doesn't corner carry that far compared
Jax's
to the original.
Jax's meter building is very good though. Come on,
only in heavy weapons is it barely good.
All right, Gabe, what do you think about this? Is this a real problem?
Please try the combos.
What's your opinion? Execution's not a factor, man. Come on,
it is when it's this inconsistent. It is when
legitimately inconsistent. Yeah, but if it's hard, if you're just saying it's hard to do,
no, it's inconsistent.
Like, that's not a point.
Like, the thing is, if you drop the run cancel forward 1-2, you get 17%.
Don't drop it.
Oh, my. This is not a Kung Lao two-frame link where you're neutral if you fuck it up right, and he builds meter for days. This is you fuck it up, you just, that's it, you've spent your 1 meter that you probably needed.
Yeah, we just covered that he has a super consistent option that still does over 30%.
That's heavy
30%
weapons.
For a bar. This is the thing, Joe. 30% for a barometer is not going to carry you very far. 30% for a barometer that doesn't grant you anything after.
I want to get Gabe's input. Here. I'm just playing devil's advocate for the most part. I want to get Gabe's input. What do you think about this problem?
In a game where you literally have to do the max damage possible for every single punish in order to win due to the amount of comeback factors that some characters have. Inconsistencies in combos forcing you to lock yourself to play as one variation is not a nice problem to have. I mean, obviously mine is in a huge, huge lesser extent, but if I want to take Melina's forward 1-2, half the cast I cannot play piercing due to the issue with T whiffing and me being full combo punished, so I have to pick Ravenous or Ethereal. Yeah. It's not a nice problem to have. I agree with that kind of sense.
I mean, Jax is a significantly better character.
But to be fair, if it's only literally max damage 30% for one bar, that's not good.
That's not good, no.
Like 30% for one bar is not great. I mean, that's like, yeah, there's no argument. There's no arguing there.
And the thing is,
not good damage for a bar.
Okay. Wait a minute, Jim. Like,
go on.
You all agree that 30% for one bar is not good, right?
It's not great. It's decent,
it's not great.
But not great.
It's not
compared to everyone else.
What's character's meterless damage? Let's see. Predator. What's Predator's meterless damage?
See, his meterless damage
isn't that good.
This bill of goods is getting sent back to the seller, man. Off of punishes. I am talking punishment. His meterless damage is not
2-1-2 neutral jump. Yeah. Back 2-2 disc. Run forward 3-2. Drop trap 24% into a trap setup.
Yeah, that's 24% into a setup. What if your setup gets you dick? That's 24%. Like,
you see, set up stuff.
Wait.
Yeah,
that's,
I'm just saying. I'm not saying it's crap.
24%, that's 24% into a setup, right?
Yeah.
That's meterless, though.
That is good.
That's meterless, 24% into a setup.
If I have meter, I get like 37 to a setup.
We're talking meterless damage into a setup.
Jax gets less meterless. Unless
Jax's
you're in corner.
Meterless isn't good. Yeah, that's true. His meterless damage.
Okay, no. What about? You know what? Let me just actually go on the character select screen. Now, Jason. I know you play Jason, Jim. What is Jason's meterless damage?
Well, I play relentless, don't I? It's like 25% at the start, or 20. No, it's 27 at the start. And then if you get two close rounds, it goes... You can't use Jason as an example, because if you get two close rounds and he hits you in the last round, right, he's doing like 40%. Like 38.
I'm gonna completely ignore Kung Lao, because we all know he gets 40% meterless. And it's unfair to compare Jax to Kung Lao when Kong Lodo's 40% and Jax has to use a bar for guaranteed 30%.
That's Kung Lao being Kung Lao, though.
Yeah. Just forget Kung Lao. We all know Liu Kang can quite possibly do 56% meterless, but that's like execution heavy, right? That's execution heavy, right? But as you said, execution.
That's when you do like 1-1. You can do it in the corner, but like you can get big damage mid screen from like doing like forward 4-4 run cancel, run forward like. Well, even okay, I'll do. This is the easy run cancel mid screen. It's like 36. If you hit forward 4-4, you can run cancel 1-1-3. That does a pop up back 3-4, forward 4-4 of a fireball or kick, right? And that's 36.
Wait, Liu Kang? Who are we talking about here?
That's
no,
Kang.
We're talking about a 56% one where you do multitudes of.
That's when you do like 1-1-3, very instant air fireball into more instant air fireballs. Into stuff like that, and that's very hard because you have to do it off the 1-1-3. You know the one where it kicks you up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know that little pop up from the 1-1-3, the one where he does the overhead kick.
Yeah,
you all know it. You can get an instant air fireball off that in the corner, and then it pops them up a little bit more. Then you have to do a slightly less instant air fireball, and you can keep doing it. Like Zarakamak has got a few videos.
I was going to mention that actually. Have you seen some of the full screen conversion stuff he posted?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. If you get hit by.
Let's just carry on. We have ruled out Kung Lao and Liu Kang, mainly because they are at the top tier of stupid meterless damage, right? The absolute top tier. Who else is out there that is just ridiculous when it comes to meterless damage? Who else?
Devorah's
meterless? What's her meterless damage?
She can get up to like 40% with the corner carry.
Oh, 40% meterless with a corner carry? Wow. That is really, really good. Shit.
Well, that might be meter. It might be like 37 with like, not meter. I don't know. She gets a lot. If she can
She can very comfortably break 30% for Nobar. Like, in this game, if you can get over 30% for Nobar,
she can do
like
a lot.
Off of like a bread and butter Punisher, then you're good. Like, you're good. If you have good meterless damage. If you
bread and butter Punishers. Yeah. Bread and butter Punishers.
Because because some characters, like, you know, I mean, we've all seen the combo videos where it's like 50% meterless that starts with a 10,000 frame jumping punch from a different game. So yeah, it doesn't count. That's not a combo. You're never landing that. Like, it doesn't count. Like, but if you can punish something, you know, super quick for 30-odd% for no bar, that's good. That's really good. In this game.
Let's go to Jax's daughter, Jackie. I know a couple of you guys play Jackie, so tell me, what's her meterless damage
play
like?
Jackie.
Yeah, when I say a couple of you guys, I mean you.
Yeah, I play Jackie. Jim doesn't play Jackie. He's not going to mess around with a character like that.
God no.
Too low tier.
Jackie's meterless.
Two no footsies.
If the sun shines upon Miss Briggs and she actually is able to punish something with standing one.
Oh, the sun! Yeah. Oh, yeah.
In full auto, she gets 32%.
Wait a minute, how easy is that? Is that relatively easy, or is it hard as balls?
It's not the easiest, to be honest. It's not, like, super hard, but it's not. Like, bit of practice, you'll get it. But yeah, that's off versus standing one. But, I mean, that's a pretty big caveat for that character, because there's a lot of stuff that standing one should punish, and it fucking doesn't.
Okay.
So, but anyway, we're talking about Jax.
Inconsistencies.
Here.
No. I'm just looking at everybody's meter list. I'm just looking across the board.
Ermac kills. Ermac hurts.
Good one.
Melina hurts, but Melina has, like, she has to do a bit of work to open you up for the big.
Yeah, Ermac's a really good one, though. Yeah, he fucking hurts.
Reptile kind of still kind of is very average, but he can get, like, yeah, he's kind of like the worst of the bunch at the moment.
Okay.
Raiden doesn't do much, but I've got a combo with Raiden where if he's in the hover in one corner, I can spend a meter and get him in the other corner, because that's what the character's designed to do, isn't it? I can literally, it's like overhead, run forward, like back 3-4 shocker, like back 3-4 run cancel, forward front 2 Superman, you're in the other corner from game.
And pretty much any combo with Raiden spawns a corner. Like, I've got one that no one's mentioned. Aaron Black. Aaron Black's meterless damage is good.
Yeah, gets about 30%, doesn't it?
Yeah, it gets like 30.
In both. Outlaw or not, Marksman. Yes. I don't think you get shit in Gunslinger, though. Sorry, Kaino gets
it. Where's my Gunslinger buffs, man?
I think Kaino gets it. Kaino gets it if he gets a whiff punish as well.
What's Kaino's damage like?
Well, if he gets like a whiff punish for like four, is it four, two, the three no slashes that launches?
Yeah,
that's good. Can get 30%.
Kitana's got good meatless damage.
Kitana's got good meatless damage.
Kouncil's got good meatless damage.
Johnny Cage has got alright meatless, but it ends
Kitana doesn't only have good meatless damage, she has good meatless unbreakable damage.
Yeah. And meted damage.
So anyway, do you want to get it back to Jax? Yeah. It seems, hang on, fuck. I almost accidentally added some random guy to the call. I don't want to do that.
just comes in, man, like Jax is the struggle, man.
So I'll be frank, like this like inconsistency with your combo problem.
Yes.
Like I'm not buying it. I gotta be honest, I'm not buying it. Not legit. This is not like a I wanted legit problems. I want something that keeps you up at night.
Okay.
I want something that keeps you up at night.
Something that keeps you up at night.
You know, 80s ballad music because you're so happy.
Have you heard of low profiling? Have you heard of that? Have you heard of low profile?
I will give you that one.
You have no pressure when you're playing against a character that can low profile your move. Yeah. No pressure at all.
Yeah. Cassie, Jay flick kicks me for you using forward two now.
Yeah. I do not dispute that at all. That is a problem for. I mean, it's a problem for more than just Jax, but that is definitely a problem.
But let me go back to the consistency, right? Let me say, I have a matchup where I would love to pick Pumped Up. Not heavy weapons, right? Because heavy weapons has a slow rocket that, like, people can, like, full screen jump and punish. Like, I don't want to be firing that rocket. But I also don't want to get in, right? I don't want to get in against this character. Say it's Devorah, right?
And, yeah, let's talk about that full screen rocket comment for a second.
There is characters that can punish it full screen. Near enough.
Just shoot it up at full screen. Like,
don't work. It has, like, a, the angle.
It's a bit weird, that angle going upwards.
Yeah, it kind of covers, like, three quarters of a screen, goes up. It doesn't, like, angle, so it goes from the bottom right to the top left.
If you pull out that rocket launcher, and they jump, and you just let it go...
But look, that's just a jump example. Like, other characters can just punish me for pulling it out and not firing it straight away. Or, like, fire it, block, and then they're in. You know what I mean? But anyway, regardless of that, I don't want to use the rocket, right?
Yeah.
Before we get onto the rocket, I want to use... Plasma and Grain Pound. So, because I've chosen those tools, I have to deal with an incredibly inconsistent combo where if I hit the overhead too far away that isn't point blank, my combo timing changes, or it may even become impossible on a female.
Yeah, but then what's your... Like, is this the possible combo that does 30-odd%?
That's what I'm saying. Should I drop my combo damage...
If you see the dash punch hits at a distance where you're unsure that you're going to get that combo.
You cannot react. You have to just... You cannot react to, like, am I going to hit this combo or not? It's consistent when you get... It's inconsistent when you get it point blank right. So, you can't go, I hit my overhead far. I've ran for a second. I'm not going to hit the 4-2-1. You can't, like... those thought processes don't occur. Because you have to, when you do the run cancel, you have to kind of piano it. It has to be a very specific piano timing. It has to be like, for run 2-1, for run 2-1. Like, that's why off the 1-2, you can just do a clean piano, where it's just forward, right trigger, 2-1, all in one motion. That's where it's more consistent. Off anything that isn't 1-2, you have to go like, run 2-1, or all depending on how far you hit the thing away.
Okay, so let's move on. I do want to like flesh out the character more. Like, you know, more problems. What's his other big problems? Like, the low profiling is definitely a thing.
In heavy weapons, he's incredibly stamina thirsty. Incredibly. So, it kind of to break against someone means that the max meterless, the max damage you're going to really get on someone with it without reverting back to what the max damage is. Like metered, you're gonna off a stand. Like, say if you hit a stand one, you can't run cancel or anything because you're broke. You can't like run cancel for like the next 10 seconds while your stamina's coming back. So your pressure's like any mind games, and your pressure's kind of like has been muted a bit in Heavy Weapons. You get to the point where you get like 20% meterless and you can't spend bars on like run combos. So you can spend a bar on an EX Gotcha if you want and get 23. So his damage becomes straight ass. Like, you don't have to be that worried about hitting him. About him hitting you. So worst he's going to do is hit you for 20% during that time. Meanwhile, you can go a bit nuts.
But no, even, I don't know. Does that problem really keep you up at nights?
But the thing
yes.
is... Yeah,
does that
the
keep
thing
you
is,
up at nights listening to Dido albums?
While the stamina...
these are the kind of problems I want, man.
I want problems that keep you up at night listening to her greatest hits. A run in the mid-screen, right? Say I want to, like, we're playing footsies, right? Mm-hmm. And I think I'm going to run in and do a 4-2-1 because I'm just out of range. If I run for too long, I can't do my combo.
Don't run for too long.
I can't run. Like, this is what, again, this is another reason why it doesn't do well against top tier, because, like, we all know, like, look at some of the speed of the runs in this game. Like, you can't react. Like, reacting to that, some of that stuff.
Reacting to run has always been a bill. Like, yeah. At certain ranges... I mean, I think we mentioned that on a really early episode, I think. But that is a huge
bill. Yeah, some of the characters' runs are really fast.
The idea of, like, I mean, full screen run, yes.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
The idea of, like,
footsie range,
mid-range run into throw, that is lightning fast. Yeah. There is no fucking way... You are reacting to that. And the proof is in the pudding, because we see people get hit by it all the damn time.
Yeah.
Like, you can do it on a read. You cannot see somebody start... Like, there's no way Sub-Zero is chilling there behind his ice clone, and he's like, right, marathon time, run and grab. There is no way you are reacting to that. Like, get out of here. Bullshit.
So, what happens is when you... Well, more heavy weapons, really. But it still has, like, its place in... the other ones because of like the amount of bar it takes
so stamina basically
what happens is
so I want to get Gabe's input. We need a balance Gabe, what are your initial thoughts? Is this a real problem?
When do I ever walk at you with Jax?
Jax against us anymore. You play other characters.
Why do you think that is the fact?
Gabe, I want to hear what Gabe thinks.
Right. What is the exact problem he was talking about?
The stamina. This has got to be a huge problem. This has got to be Melina's down one kind of problem. That keeps you up at night.
This is a problem this is one of the things that keeps him from, like, the top tier again. This is one of the problems that keeps him from competing with, like, some characters. Like, and it's real, like, in a game, it's just one of them, in a game where there's run... In the neutral, right, in a footsie range, my character suffers big time for using
that
it.
That said, I do want to add one.
Because he's so stamina thirsty.
In terms of stamina, I don't think there are actually many players that are really, really good at managing stamina yet. I just want to say that. Like, that's not a knock on anybody, I'm not, but, like, I think a lot of players haven't really adjusted to that.
I was really good at managing my stamina. There's no amount of stamina management that can let me do run into 4-2-1, into run cancel 1-2, into run cancel combo, because that's too many runs.
That's an aspect of the game, though. Like, I mean, I could say the same thing about Scorpion. I could say, oh, I can't do run cancel.
It brings me back.
Run cancel 2-1, run cancel 2-1, like, into a combo. I shouldn't be able to do that. But F0xy Grampa, that's just EX teleported into the show. How's it going, man?
Alright. What's up? What's the topic of conversation?
Jax.
Jax. We're talking about Jax's horrible.
This episode is Majesty's struggle.
Alright.
I want to get Gabe's thoughts, man. Gabe, what do you think about this topic, about the stamina? Like, Jax's stamina being a huge problem.
He's such a big man, he doesn't do much cardio.
Go on.
What do you think, Gabe? I would say if you were forced to open up an echo.
Where is this echo coming from?
Hold on.
That's a good point.
Hold on, I'll stick my mic on.
Okay.
Right. You may resume.
Bye. Carry on, Gabe.
If you are forced to open up an opponent four times, like in a match, instead of three, due to the reduction of damage you have to do due to something, then that is an issue. But on the grand scheme of things, it doesn't feel like a massive problem to me.
Alright, let's
start this.
Come on, guys. You guys have made your cases. Like,
this
brings you back.
No, one thing Jim hasn't mentioned, you notice he said like he's gotta run three times. No, every time you do a rocket cancel with Jax, it takes a 30 a bar.
That's true for any fireball cancel.
Characters take less.
No. For dash cancels, yes. For run cancels, that's the same for every character that can do that.
No. Like, it's a run cancel. It doesn't take a third. You remember when we were doing Scorpions 1 in the hotel, and he could do, like, 4 or 5 run cancels?
No.
Run cancels off the fucking...
Bullshit.
Jim.
No, he couldn't. I made
Jim.
That character. He could never
Jim.
Do 4 or 5 run cancels.
What could
do 5? I know you could definitely do 3.
You can do 3. That's the same. Fireball cancelling, if you do it perfectly, you can get 3 run
cancels. Yeah, that's 3 run cancels. Jax only does 2 if you put it like that. Because he doesn't have the stamina to do another run.
Scorpion. I'm going to test that, because I've tested that with Jax. But
what I was going to say was,
I've tested that with every other character, and it's 3 run cancels. Every character can do 3.
What I was going to say, right, so... When I was saying with heavy weapons, I got to run in, and if I want to run in and combo into like my easier combo, it don't work because I'd have to run 3 times,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's a problem.
If
I think that's a problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like if my change of the EX dash punch popping them up, right? It reduces corner carry. It'd technically be a nerf, right? Because he wouldn't corner carry you as far, so the bullshit in the corner wouldn't get as tired as quick. I could run in. I could play the run game in the neutral and combo you. And it would be consistent in the other two variations, and it wouldn't corner carriers less. Is that not a fair, like, change?
Yeah, that's the dash punch thing. Like, that's...
But that's it, all the problems kind of, like, all the little things kind of come together to kind of create this, like, character that can do all this stuff, but it's like typing your AOL password out, and it just, you keep saying you forgot it, and you're sure you remember how to do it.
That's a good analogy, I like that.
You're sure you remember how to do it, but it's saying check your email, and you've got none, so...
Jax, well, yeah, the stamina thing is a problem. Because, you know, you need to run at people sometimes, and when you do have that opportunity to run at people, you ain't getting shit out of it.
That's it. Like, when I walk at Foxy...
And the problem with Jax is he doesn't really get much damage anyway, as it is.
That's it, unless I have the stamina to, like, really convert. But the thing is, if I played, like, if I got the pop-up in, like, wrestler or heavy weapons, I wouldn't have to run cancel into a string that scales my damage by, like, 5%. So I could get the 40% meter, or whatever.
Have you seen the resurgence of Tekken Masters, his mate, XSEs? You seen the thread?
No.
It's the Middle East MKX tier list. They've put up their tier list, whatever, and then he's gone and said...
Jax is top.
Yeah, they put Jax as top tier with Kung Lao, Quan Chi, Shinnok, Predator.
That's a fucking lie.
Where is this thread?
And I said, Jax isn't top, and Buzzsaw is better than what you know Buzzsaw to be. Which is reasonable, because I am the only Buzzsaw player. Okay. So you can't really know unless you play me. It's the same as the Pig Kenshi thing, isn't it? You can't know Kenshi until you play Pig.
I'm just curious.
It's actually
Mortal Kombat X strategy zone.
It's on the front page.
Oh, okay. I wasn't on the front page.
His mate has basically gone and said Tekken Master is the master, and he's going to come and slap Europe up. But he said that before.
Damn.
Damn.
Shots fired.
But last time it was just me. Yeah, last time it was just me there. This time PND will be there. He's going to a red bike district. You guys going?
Very likely, yeah. Very likely.
Yeah, I'll probably come.
Yeah, because yeah, you definitely need to be there, Adam. You need a Jax off because this guy. I can't decide who's the best Jax between you and him.
Oh, more times I've got to play it. Can't I just play Bone Shaper and just beat a string? Or play Hunter and just throw 40% traps down?
Goro's got his own even tier on trade in this tier list.
Because his Jax is like, he does some good stuff and whatnot. But he's very risky.
Yeah.
Whereas that's you're very safe.
That's a good
thing. What the hell does he do fucking risky?
He does 1-2 overhead punches.
Yeah, or just like 1-2-3.
Is that even a risk?
That's like a minus 25 risk, is it?
That's what lost him. Yeah, that's what lost him the tournament. This is like, why would you do that against Tempest?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I think
it's like doing 1-1-2-1-2 spin. Like, why would you do that?
Yeah.
Right. Let's talk about Jackie. Let's talk about Jax's door. I do want to talk about Jackie. What do you think about Jackie, Foxy? Seeing as you're on the show, we've got you on. Might as well pick your brain. What do you think about Jackie? Mainly referring to full auto, as that is kind of...
Full auto. She's pretty shit, to be honest. I know that certain characters can punish her for shooting a gun, so... Without
pretty
a gun,
she's
got...
2-2.
That must mean that Kung Lao can probably get run in 4-2 or something.
Yeah,
but that's pretty bad, and the fact that she's got no range sort of kills her, doesn't it?
Yeah.
She's a character by design that like works on paper but doesn't in game. Because she's got, on paper, she's got a fast jab, a good mid with that forward one. Reasonable everything, but like when it's actually... Like Justin said, she's got T-Rex arms, isn't she? She's the Sektor.
Yeah, the standing one range is like my biggest problem with her, because she is a secondary of mine, and that is the thing that annoys me the most, is when someone does something that's like, you know, minus 11 or minus 10.
Could you say it's not very consistent?
No, it's not
properly.
It's consistent. It's consistently shit. It's like, you know. It's not inconsistent. It's just bad. Like, you know, it doesn't punish some stuff some of the time. It can't punish some stuff all of the time, and that's just like, that's terrible. The moves where she can punish, like the characters where they have stuff that is like, can be punished by her standing one, it's awesome, because it's a really good punish. It's a good punish for Jack. I do think forward one is really good. I think forward one is a good move. That's a good mid. It's fast. It covers. It's got good range. She's got good options from it. You can establish, like, if they are unfortunate enough to block an up rocket, you can establish stuff after that. I think her corner game is ridiculous. Like, I really do think her corner game is good. But mid-screen is where I think she does struggle.
She's got like a buzzsaw sort of corner game, isn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Kind of, yeah. And but with the one difference, if you do, like, if you're willing to bet big, the reward is big.
What if her main problems as well is a bad, like, reversals?
That's true. That's not good. The Force's charge is awful. Like, that's really bad.
Alright, like, Joe, I just spent a little bit in the training mode with Scorpion, and I looked at his run cancel. His run cancel only uses a quarter of his bar.
Post a video where you can do 2-1-4, 2-1-4, 2-1-4, 2-1-4. That's 4 run cancels. I'll bet you £1 million that's impossible.
Alright.
Post a video.
Are you on my Xbox?
Run cancels.
Run Xbox One.
I want run cancels.
No. Yeah, you're saying that you can only do 3. You might be able to do 4 if you get it like spot on.
Yeah. If you can, I want to see it.
Zerakamak would be the one to ask to do that.
Yeah, he's the run cancel guy.
Okay, yeah. If it's true, I definitely want to see it, but as far as I know, you can only do 3. And, like, that seems to be the thing. Okay,
Jim's doing it as well.
Yeah, Jim's fired up.
I'm not doing it.
Oh, it's dead. Okay.
What's his fireball?
Scorpion. Down forward one, down back one.
Down back one, alright.
It's down back one, yeah. Gabe, what do you think about Jackie?
She kind of feels almost incomplete in design. She has like some good stuff going for her, but as we said, she's got consistently rubbish range of her normals. Some things that I said, as Foxy said, that should work on paper doesn't work in practice. But yeah. I don't think she needs that much in terms of changes to make her a viable character. Well, I'd say a good character. She doesn't need that much.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. I
think that's the same with a lot of characters that are struggling against the top tier. They're really good characters that are struggling against the top tier. And if they're buffed in stupid ways, they'll be fucking stupid characters. And I don't want that to happen. It's like you have a candy bar. You have this candy bar, and this candy bar is really nice, but it's not as nice as that next candy bar. And if they put a little bit of sugar on this candy bar, it's going to be like super S top tier candy bar. And you don't want that. You want to still have your candy bar that nobody else wants to play because it's a really, really specific tasting candy bar. And just by yourself with your small community of candy bar eaters. That's what you want.
Candy. Who says that?
Yeah, I agree. That's a blow up. It's chocolate bar, dude.
It's candy bar.
Candy bar. Get out of here. Get out of here with that shot.
Yeah, I
do agree.
Yeah, I can't get more than three.
Yeah, bullshit. You cannot do four run cancels. Dread, just in case you haven't, make sure you infinite stamina's not on.
No, infinite.
But I'm shit. I don't play a character with a run cancel, remember.
Yo, Jim.
What?
The Scorpion's run cancel.
Try the Scorpion run cancels.
Oh, I'd have to turn my PlayStation on, switch to money.
You can catch that shit later. Yeah, like, the stuff I give to Jackie is always, when I mention it to Justin, and he thinks it's really conservative, I don't think it is. Like, I really do think it's all she needs, is a faster standing one, and a good down one, and a good down four. I think that would do a lot to help that character. Like, I really do. I think it would do a lot to help her. So let's move on. New topic. Plus frames. Let's talk about plus frames.
Well, the master of plus frames is here, so let's start with that.
Exactly. Yeah. He came on at just the right time. Plus frames. Are they good, or are they only good if they jail into something? What do you guys think? I'll start with Foxy, seeing as his first time on the show, and he plays Kung Lao, the god of plus frames. So, what do you think, Foxy?
I think in this game they have to jail. Purely because of shit like mashing armored option selects and all that bollocks.
Yeah.
And the fact that a lot of players just don't want to block, so they're going to mash armor anyway. And a lot of, well, especially for Kung Lao as well, because if his plus frames didn't jail, he'd have to, his game plan would completely change around.
Yeah, I agree. So it's kind of an anticlimactic.
It's like the buzzsaw it. Plus frames. You can get plus four off the EX low hat, but no one really gives a shit about that.
Nah.
Yeah, because it doesn't jail.
Plus
frames are good, but they're not great unless they jail.
I disagree with Foxy. I disagree with Foxy for the base level of, if you have plus frames, that's a really good thing. If the other character doesn't have
plus... it depends. Because, like, you've got Jax, who can just do 1-1, and that's the start of his game, isn't it? So.
But that's not plus. That's just neutral. It recovers real quick. That's what it
1-1
is.
1-1 isn't neutral, it's plus.
It is. It's neutral, motherfucker.
It's fucking plus.
Put that shit on training mode. 1-1, let the computer jump. That shit is neutral. Don't listen to the goddamn frame data. The frame data is incorrect. Incorrect.
Jim, what do you think? What do you think about this?
I think from guaranteed pressure, the main like big thing is it opens up for a throw every time, and in this game, to spend bar to get guaranteed throws is kind of like really good, because say if you have like three bars and you have a way to jail your opponent, you can pretty much get 36%. I know that's pretty crappy, but probably if you tack on all the chip that you're getting on top of that, that can, like, be 50.
But, I don't think it's crap. I think throws are really
Yeah,
throws because... kind of factor into like that.
Yep,
kind
definitely of... not neutral.
Like throws.
Neutral.
Throwing.
No, it's like... definitely think... not neutral, you idiot.
Neutral, motherfucker.
It's not. Look, go into practice with Jax. Listen. Go into practice with Jax. Do what, like, with both, like, two Jaxes, right? Do 1-1 on block, and if you can 1-1 him out of his next 1-1, or
you won't. You won't be. You won't be able to because you have one framer on blocking.
So it's not neutral. It's not neutral. You can't if you can't trade. It's not. It's not fucking neutral.
The bait.
And I'm not. Yeah, I've not even traded one hit here, and all I'm doing is 1-1. It's plus. Guarantee you.
It's plus because of the system of the game. It's not plus.
Yeah, but plus one's better than nothing.
Yeah.
I think it's more than plus one.
Would you rather be? Would you rather be plus one or would you rather be minus one?
Then set the dummy to jump.
It's not about the jump, is it? If you can get a trade on the same move, that's the way to test it. But it's not. Yeah. It's not. I haven't traded once, and I've been doing this whole time. And I'm stand blocking. It's not even like I'm crouch blocking.
I like he can just hear it in the back.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, look, this is the sound of him doing 1-1-1-1 back to back, and I'm trying to 1-1 him out of it. It's not working.
I can just hear this hit on the second one.
Yeah. Okay, what do you think about this? What do you think about this topic?
Plus frames, you mug.
I think, realistically, in almost every other fighting game, or fighting games that I've played anyway, when you're a plus...
I've just 1-1 myself on top of 1-1.
Well, you're doing it wrong, man, because I can't.
You gotta know that he recovers fucking quick.
No, you're doing it wrong. I guarantee you... Why would I even listen to you? You don't know about fucking execution. You can't execute 1-1 back-to-back with 1-1.
I just fucking don't...
Like, you can't. You can't even get it. You're getting it wrong.
Carry on, Gabe. What do you think?
Plus frames, usually, it's supposed to be a great thing because you have advantage. You can move whenever you want, almost sometimes do whatever you want before your opponent can do anything. Or at least your opponent will have to always respect your next option. In a game where a lot of moves have armor and not many characters have quick enough strings to stuff it, plus frames doesn't mean as much as it should do. However, that is probably just unique to this game and IRS style. I don't know, but I don't feel it should really be that way.
You mean specifically on block?
Yeah.
Yeah, Dredd, you are chatting some shit. This is
it's not
happening.
How many characters had like stuff like that in MK9 and any justice that was like guaranteed jails? Like, I'll let you lost
My memory's not that good on that.
Cabal. Cabal, yeah, but that was because it was basically an infinite.
Yeah, Cabal was kind of a unique example, really. There's not many characters that. I don't think there was anyone that had his pressure, like, in MK9 apart from him.
I'm looking at, Well, in just
did Cage have anything guaranteed? I know you played Cage.
Only after his nut punch on hit, he didn't have anything on block.
Nah, right, okay.
So, yeah, he was like plus five, I think, on his force balls. So it's pretty much the same as the buzzsaw low hat, or it's like one frame difference.
Okay, but like, I mean, I know Injustice is a different like beast because there's no kind of reversals in Injustice.
Yeah. Everyone was plus on loads of shit in Injustice, weren't they?
The mix-ups, well, there was a few. The mix-ups was... Some characters had, like, stupid mix-ups.
But the backdashes worked in that game, so... Yeah. It didn't really matter so much.
Oh, man, pre-patch Black Adam backdash. Nightmares to this day.
Just your nightmares. It seems like we're all pretty universal on that, but I do agree. Mm-hmm. I think, like, plus frames are good, but, you know, they're basically not really, really good. Unless you're guaranteed something, which kind of sucks, really.
Yeah, you get 10 times more mind games. Okay, that's why I still think Jax. That's why I think Jax can perfectly win any tournament, right? Ooh.
What's wrong?
You sound like you're in a submarine.
Yeah.
Let me try to do things that I don't know if I can. Let me plug up my thing.
Okay.
Alright, carry on, Jim. Sorry, what were you saying?
That's why I still think like Jax can like win a thing, because Jax, like, because he's like plus up a lot of stuff, right?
Is it fine now?
He's only slightly plus, and like that's all he needs to kind of like play the game plan I think they intended for him. Like his game plan is intended to like 1-1 you or 4-2-1. Then when you're gonna go for a poke, he pokes you to get plus frames, and when you're not going for a poke, he just 50-50s your ass and guesses right.
Like I think yeah, that's pretty much it. It's Wonder Woman.
Yeah,
that's
like
what
that's,
it is.
Yeah, that's his game plan. It's like, okay, I'm gonna do this. And I know what you're gonna do next. You're gonna be so scared of my 1-1, you're gonna block low. It's way overhead, Jan. You're like, oh, you got away with like plus 2 into an 18 frame overhead. But like in a game where characters have like the guaranteed jail stuff, I think that's slightly better.
Yeah.
But in theory, Jax could be this monster of man, I can't do anything because every time I've reversed his baited out, every time I've gone for a poke, he's poked me. Every time I've sat there, I've blocked wrong. You know what I mean? That's the kind of... But in theory...
Yeah, but the problem with his 50-50 is they're kind of slow, aren't they?
Well, you started, react like, to him. Yeah, you started reacting to the overhead, which is like 18 frames, which is a bit disgusting, but...
It's like Kung Lao's overhead, you can react to that.
Nah.
Or should I say mid?
Yeah, it's a mid. Because this is how it works out, right? Kung Lao has all mids, and then he's down forwards and unblockable. Yeah.
No, that is true. That is completely true.
Yeah.
You gotta understand, if you ever block high, if you ever not block high, you're dead. So the down four is unblockable, so you should just never block the down four.
Just get down four to death.
And just accept. And
a
just
slow,
try, and
painful
just, and
death.
Just look
down
and, four. And just commit to the gap in the stagger. Don't
yeah,
try and like
just,
block
just,
the down four and get out. Because then you see a hat come over your head and it hurts real bad. So just accept the down four. It's like your best friend. He's the enemy you keep closer.
Just take the hit, bro. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Just take the hit.
Such great
just
advice.
Take the hit. No, that's how it is. That's exactly how it is. You can't hope to just sit there and...
Jay wants to join the call as well.
Someone try and add him in. But...
Denim, you probably can drag him in.
Yeah, you should be able to.
So, let me see.
So let's talk about the stamina gauge real quick, actually. I do want to talk about that. We mentioned it a bit with Jax. What do you guys feel about the stamina gauge in the game? Do you think it needs to be altered? Like stamina penalties, what things cost, etc., etc.? Gabe,
yeah,
I'll start with you.
The cost of things, yeah.
Gabe, what do you think?
In Breakers, they take too long.
I don't know if I can. I don't know if it works.
If you can add me, then I should be able to get him on.
I'll see what his name is.
Okay. But yeah, carry on, Gabe.
I think in Breakers, they take too long to regenerate, because how the movement works in this game, it does feel like you can't really move that much or as well, unless you have stamina to do run. And the amount of times...
Or backdashes as well, like it's not just run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to say backdashes as well. Well, backdash is just dependent. I don't mind it costing the bar, but it's only really good if you have a really good backdash. When you've got someone like
no,
Kano.
I just meant in terms of a breaker. When you've broke, you can no longer backdash.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So if you break mid-screen and you want to get away, it's like, you know, you
yeah,
can't.
Yeah, it's more. And it's, I don't know, it's just annoying. It's like some the amount of times I've got Foxy would corner me and then get hit by the pressure, I decided to break.
Yeah,
because I can't move. He just runs into about dash distance and just sits there, and I'm just like, great, here we go again.
Yeah.
So you just broke, we can do.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically.
How long are you gonna sit there?
That's what I mean. So I think it needs to recharge faster, just due to how the movement works in this game.
I agree. I agree on that. I think that is definitely the case. Like, not too fast, but definitely faster than what it does now. Like, it's like forever and a day.
That's one of my biggest complaints on the block breaker system, is that if there was like, because the block breaker system, it costs 2 bars, and or it costs the same as a breaker at the moment, so it's kind of like, what's the point? There isn't many points. Unless it's going to die from getting too low.
It's kind of like push block and Injustice was different.
But like in this game, even if it costs you're gonna die, the 2 bars, if it kept my stamina, I would use that stuff. I would use that tool so much more, because I wouldn't be dead. Like, I'd still have a defensive option. Like, I've chose the not getting hit option, right? So, can you at least reward me with stamina so I can at least have a defensive backdash? Or I can at least, the guy won't run in and just hit my face, because I'm literally just standing there and I can only move the direction to his face.
Yeah.
Right?
For breakers, just to throw out some ideas, get you guys thinking. For breakers, what if they took 2 bars a meter still, but only half your stamina?
You had a backdash that you could like intelligently use. I'd like it.
Yeah, like, I mean, it's not the best, but I mean, you have still broken out of a combo, you have
a defensive option, because you spend a breaker as a defensive option, right? Mm-hmm. And then you have given up
everything.
You've given up stamina and stamina.
Exactly.
In this
game. Yeah, like, what would you guys think about that? If they kept the same, it's still 2 bars a meter, but you keep half your stamina for a breaker. And while I'm at it, like, just for the sake of argument, the regen time isn't altered. Like, is it more the regen time, or is it more the amount?
The regen time is the main crutch, because after you break...
Well, this is for stamina-heavy characters. Yeah, for any stamina-heavy character.
Yeah, I don't give a shit when I break. It's like, yeah. Stick up the Tempest hat and throw out forward twos or do what I want. Yeah, as long as orbit hat hits.
For any character that doesn't need stamina to do any damage, it doesn't really matter. But it only doesn't matter to them if they have really good normals. What I think they should do is... I don't know, the whole...
So you think the regen time is the bigger deal, not that it takes all your buffs?
The regen time is a really big deal, but yeah, I like the regen time. I'm in two fucking worlds here, right? The regen time is really, really good, because you broke, you got me off of you, but what are you going to do after that? What are you going to do after that?
That's kind of what makes the breaker system interesting, though, because when you're the aggressor and someone breaks your combo, you know, part of you thinks, okay, yeah, I didn't do my full damage, but I just took all your meter and all your stamina, so you're still kind of, you know, you got something off them. And if you're a character that's got, like, kind of really good pressure, like, if you, you know,
what would
break against, like, if you do break against Kung Lao, it's like, well, great.
Like, what about, you know? What about if we do it the other way? What about if we take 1 bar a meter, but all your stamina? You still have some defensive options, because you still have meter.
Yeah, but then you'd just be breaking, you'd just be getting hit.
Yeah, I think the problem with it being 1 bar is that it favours the characters that build meter significantly.
I'd have 3 breakers at a time, man.
Yeah.
And I don't use stamina in combos.
Oh, yeah.
I think that was Injustice's problem. Injustice, like, the clash system was really good for some characters, but it fucked other characters. Because, I mean, characters like Wonder Woman. When you clashed Wonder Woman, it was like, yeah.
You always win.
Yeah.
You always.
Good times.
Like Gabe's Wonder Woman, man. Like, we have a really good set going. A really good set. I'm Grundy, I'm working overtime, and this dick clashes my combo.
And then you're full screen. You're full screen against Zod, who is never on the floor, and you can't reverse any of your fireballs. Yeah. So, and you're just like, why?
I think that's the issue with it being like, I think it does need to stay 2 bars of meter. Like, no matter what they do with stamina, 100%. It needs to stay 2 bars of meter. Because... You'll just have characters breaking, like, you'll touch them and it's like, yeah, I don't care, bro. Like, Cabal and MK9, you always had Breaker, and it was 2 bars then, but I mean, you always had Breaker, it's part of what made him good. Like, most of the time you touched him, he just had a Breaker, so you didn't get your damage. So I think 2 bars of meter does need to stay. I think it is, like, the stamina system specifically that needs to be addressed. What about backdashes? What do you guys think about
backdashes? Backdashes are shit. They need to work.
I couldn't say that was what I was going to say basically, but like changing them, like what if you could backdash three times?
Nah, two is enough. You just need to make it actually invincible.
Yeah, it, like
Shinnok works, and then like there's that's
Kung Lao. What's the point in Kung Lao's backdash? He doesn't do anything. He just hops backwards so he can take a punch to the face.
Yeah. I want everyone to like this is a good measurement of it. Everybody take a minute and just imagine that you had Kano's backdash. Don't you feel better?
Oh my god!
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
That would be
don't
so
you feel
good.
Better
that would change. If like Kung Lao in Hat Trick had a better backdash with no hat on his head, it'd be good.
Yeah, I think in Hat Trick he should kind of get the Ferritor adjustments, you know, where he throws Ferret and then he gets a better down one or
yeah, that sort of shit.
That'd make the character
the recovery
more interesting
as well, because there are some strings that like, yeah. I mean, like it's a common thing to see on
the advancing strings.
You'll see like, oh, that thread can be backdashed, and it's like, yeah, it can be, but you can't get anything out of it. It's like you backdash the string. More often than not, your backdash is like, you know, terrible. So you don't cover, you don't make any ground.
Like
still in your face, and you got less stamina.
Yeah, you got less stamina there at advantage than there probably.
Sweet. My reverse.
It's like Jax's back three down two. You can backdash that. What's the fucking point?
But it's like Injustice with Green Lantern back 1-3. If you backdash that, it was a little tough, but depending on your backdash, but you got like a full combo punish.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And like when people started doing that, like Green Lantern players did mention it, it's like yeah, that changes matchups.
Yeah, just so like you had to do like back 1 minigun. That was like a new string.
Yeah.
See, it was hardest to confirm the back ones against really good players because you can do back 1-3, see, hit, and then go trade, grab.
Yeah. Yeah, I do think backdashes need to be buffed for sure. They, at the moment, I think like in terms of like strings and that, I don't think it's worth it personally.
Because the thing
I
is,
I don't think it's worth it to backdash.
The scary thing about backdashing is like, okay, I'll backdash, but if he's read my backdash, I have to eat this 40% or. I have to eat this big ton of damage because I can't break.
Yeah. And there's things that's the orbit hat. If you backdash that, he can just run at you. You don't even have to react or anything. He just runs with a hat up and you're still getting punished.
Yeah.
But that's the thing about backdashes in this game. It's like in Injustice, I was totally in my comfort zone. Like if an opponent was being fidgety and panicky and they loved to press a lot of buttons and they didn't, you know, they just tried to lock you down with down ones and they thought that's how the game was going to be. You could backdash out on a read and you didn't have to deal with that. In this game, you've got invincible backdashes, but the backdashes are so bad for most of the cast that you kind of have to play the MK9 game and you kind of have to sit there and you have to play the game they want to play, even if it's, you know, even if it's crap, you have to kind of do it. And if backdashes were a little bit stronger and buffed a little more, you wouldn't have to put up with a lot of the opponent's crap. You could just backdash out on a read. And in this game, it still doesn't really work. And it's the only thing, it's probably one of the only things in this game I dislike. It's the fact that the backdashes are not as strong as they should be. And it's a fundamental part of it, a fighting game, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
and it's not there.
I agree. I mean, for the sake of the topic, can you guys think of anything that is backdashable that can also be punished if you do so? Can you guys think of anything?
There's not a lot in the game.
Okay, what was that? What you can punish
for the sake of the topic, can you think of anything like a string that is backdashable but can actually be punished if you do so?
Nah, no.
Not really.
Not off the top
but
of my head.
For me, like Kong Lois 4-4, if you play a character like, alright, Liu Kang's 1-1-3 should be a string that the opponent can't just do, considering they have such a strong low game, right? And then Kong Lao, opponents you can't open up because they haven't got a lot of mistakes they can make. There should be holes in offense, like 4-4, which we know there is with Kong Lao. You actually can't backdash and punish that, which you should be able to do. And same with Liu Kang's 1-1-3, because there are some characters you can't, they don't really make mistakes unless they jump into you or do something stupid. And there's almost nothing in this game you can do that with, which is why parry's in this game. Another thing, I thought parry, when I sing like Unbreakable Parry, I thought this is going to be amazing. And there's nothing in the game you can parry, so therefore there's nothing in the game you can backdash and punish. So, all that stuff's right up there with lack of anti-airs in this game, which, Jesus Christ, man. Like, unless you're Tempest Lau, which is why he's so good, and let's forget about, like, all the other stuff he has. Like, the anti-air is the best thing about him and why he dominates a lot of characters is you can't jump with a bar meter. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, that's the golden thing. It's like that before this game came out, I said to myself, I'm going to win tournaments with anti-airs and throwing hats. Yeah, and that was it.
12 gauge, come out of the submarine.
I'm in hard again.
Yeah. Anti-airs, counter-poking with strings and throws. Yeah, those are the three things.
It's just like this game, I mean, it's just... Man, fundamental stuff's just missing. Yeah. I mean, the fact you can't manage your meter properly. I've never not broken combos more in any game than I have in this one. Because it's like that alone. The lack of anti-airs, the lack of backdashing, and then the fact you can't break because it's not worth it, and you can't block break. It's like those three things. If they were addressed, the game would be perfect. It will be
closed. I don't think the breakers is that big of a deal, though.
Well, that's
not a game changer.
Well, I know in most fighting games don't have a breaker, right? But
fighting
games aren't doing 45% with a hard knockdown. Like sometimes a breaker is you need to do it, and in this game, it's so not worth it. And it's a fundamental, whether you like it or not, it's a part of an MK fighting mechanic. It has been since MK4, I want to say.
Was when breakers came in.
It's in the game, and now it's like not a part of the game anymore. And push block was massive in Injustice. It was like the reason you could beat Batgirl sometimes. I mean, and now it's not.
Really?
Anymore,
like, when
sometimes,
did that happen?
I mean, well, you know what I mean. It's like there apart from better backdashes and better anti-airs and just not ruining you when you take a breaker. Like, just half a bar of stamina and push block should be half a bar and a bar of mana. So, we know the game's excellent.
Is it still going?
Yeah, you still got it, man. What's going on?
I don't know what's going on. What
the hell?
But yeah, just those three things, I think. Man, they just...
Alright, anyway, let's get off topic here. Final topic, seeing as a patch is likely incoming, what do you guys want, but more importantly, what do you expect? Jim, we'll start with you.
Okay, this...
Start with what you want.
Well, it's kind of what I want and what I expect. Okay. If they do not address anti-airs, this game will remain fundamentally flawed in its current state. The amount of times, like... When I was playing Ryan with Predator, the amount of times I tried to down to him after he jumped out the corner, I hit it once out of about 12 times, and he just stuffed me every time. I can't... If I try and anti-cross-up with, like, a character that doesn't have, like... even if it has something like a good anti-cross-up, right? Half the time I trade with some of these insane jump normals that, like...
Yeah. So, moves that are designed to anti-air don't anti-air.
Yes. Uh-huh. Like, have you ever seen me in... Honestly, I've done it once in tournament. Let's see if you can remember. Let's see if you can remember the move. What is Jax's anti-air design special?
It's like gotcha grab.
The grab.
No.
The knee.
All right, it took you two guesses to get a move. Can you name the one time I've done it in tournament?
I bet it lost you a match, though.
No, I actually won the match. It was against the first MK Cup against the Devorah. When I already was going to jump, and I did it. I've used that move.
So let's talk about the anti-airs, though. What do you actually garbage. Want them to do? Because that's something that's talked about a lot on the forums, actually.
I want them to anti-air.
I wouldn't say, like people want down twos to work.
No, I don't want down twos.
Down two is not the answer. No. It should be like MK9.
I want punishment to work. I want somebody to jump, you press a button, and you get a combo. That's what I want.
MK9
style anti-airs, or leave it as it is, because I can't bother to deal with down twos.
The thing is, though, you got to look at what that entails. That entails reducing the active frames on jump normals, and it entails increasing the active frames on standing normals and potentially standing normal hitboxes. It's like you got to think like what it's going to alter. Because that's the thing, that sometimes things get altered in these games. You know, they'll patch something, and people don't think it's that big of a deal. But as the game progresses, you realize it's a snowball effect.
What would come from giving a jab more active frames?
It'd regulate space longer in a tight situation. Just off the top of my head.
Yeah, but it wouldn't really.
If you've got a mid, like... I'm just saying...
At the highest level, you can't afford to miss a jab.
It wouldn't change
anything. You play against Sonic Pucks, you miss a jab, you die.
Mm. Yeah. But I'm just saying, like, think about, like, what it would change. Like, well, how would you change it personally, Jim?
I'd just make... Yeah, just reduce the active frames on the jump normals, or just give them less priority and make jabs a thing.
I think the priorities are big.
And fix the hitboxes on some of them. Some of the hitboxes are absolutely ridiculous.
Leave Kung Lao's jump to as it is.
Leave that funny. But like, when me and Madsen was going over the Sub-Zero and Bone Shaper, we was testing what he could do to get out of some of the corner stuff. And I said, okay, I'll do the string on block, or I'll do something on block. Now, you jump out and I'll try and down two. If he did an in-snare jump one, it would beat my down two with Shinnok, which is 7 frames and one of the best every time. Because as he left the ground with the instant jump one, the hitbox extended far enough to hit him about... to hit Shinnok about 5-6 frames off the ground. And guaranteed beat my down two. Like, less than 7 frames. And I was pretty happy doing it. Yeah.
What if they buff down twos? Like, what if down twos kind of become, like, Injustice style?
Yeah, but that's not a good thing. You don't want down twos like Injustice, because Injustice, you could do something with them, and MK, you can't. So it'd just be an uppercut. It'd be no different.
I just want consistency. I want someone to jump, and for me to be able to react and stop them jumping.
Yeah. I think that's what everybody wants.
That is my...
interesting to,
like,
talk about why would it...
That's
know,
what the EX spins for, man.
Yeah, that's, like...
Have you noticed all Jax players wants are consistency? That's it. Just consistency. That's all we want.
Yeah, but no one cares about you Jax players.
It's all about consistency. Nothing else matters.
You're all a bunch of crybabies.
because at the moment, like, with the offenses in this game, like, the offense is very much more... like, it's slightly ahead of... let's be honest, it's ahead of defense at this point. But if you take away my fundamental defensive options, right, it's like imagine if in Street Fighter you couldn't show you can. You had to try and time a very specific stand jab, not even like a crouch heavy punch, and people just jumping over and fucking doing shit.
By the way, guys, I was on a phone call and I missed a lot of that conversation. Where are we at right now?
Final topic. Joe said, what do you want from the patch? And I just basically said,
you were saying anti-airs, and you guys were talking about, like, some answers for anti-airs. The problem, right?
More so what you want, what you expect from the patch.
But we'll just really quickly, like, 30 seconds on the anti-air thing. The problem with anti-airs isn't the fact that they're really that bad. There are some decent anti-airs. The problem is the trade-off doesn't work. For instance, you know, jumping attacks can lead to like 50%, where an anti-air leads to like 20. So the only thing they might need to do is, if they're going to make anti-airs a thing, they need to just increase the amount of damage you get from an anti-air. The game has to know you anti-aired the guy.
Yeah,
and that, yeah, you give know, the EX spin more damage.
Yeah,
no.
The deal is, I understand what they're trying to do. They realized in MK9 that characters with an excellent ground game also could standing one jab you out of the air with almost any character. And then they realized, okay, so you can't jump. And that's cool, because that's fundamental and it's clean. But then characters that were awesome on the ground, like you played against Johnny Cage, you couldn't approach him on the fucking ground. And then you got in the air and he knocked you out of the air. And I know what they're trying to
punch
do. They're trying to say, space out the opponent better, so when they jump, you can whiff punish them. But the problem I find is, why can an opponent jump attack and immediately block?
They can't.
No, that doesn't, yeah, no, it's harder really. To do in this game.
No, but not really.
It's much harder.
Not entirely.
No, really.
Alright, then, okay.
I discard Kung Lao players for doing jump two.
Maybe you're saying that, but what about characters that have excellent jump two? The characters that jump, the characters that jump a lot are the characters with the best jumping normals. Do you know how many times I've spaced out a jump in for Quan Chi or Kung Lao to hit me anyway? And then when they land, you haven't got a normal long enough to reach where they landed. So I'm saying, like, look, the anti-air thing is what it is in this game, but they need to either give universal buffs and make anti-airs have less priority over stand normals, or the game has to know you anti-aired and buff that fucking damage. it's want to make a trade off better. I mean, why would a Kong Lao player? Why would a Kong Lao player really care about?
So well, no, to be honest, they did make the damage more because you remember in MK9, anti airs used to scale. In this, they don't.
Yeah, that's a good point.
And air to airs as well.
Yeah. Air to airs in MK scaled a hell of a lot more, whereas in this game, yeah, it was the same within like Injustice. It was down twos, like down twos scaled your shit in Injustice. If you had an anti-air that wasn't down two, it was tight because it was like, yeah, my damage isn't getting scaled.
Well, look, dude, when it comes to the topic of the patch, the only thing I really want, right, that I expect them to round off the remaining variations that are currently useless. They know this is a tournament game. They know it. They know it's being used in tournaments, so there's no excuse to say, well, don't really worry about random Takeda, Ronin, or whatever. Don't worry about Unbreakable Sub or Patrick Lawyer or whatever. Yeah. They have to round them off because they know the game's got major attention. There's a second season at ESL, so I expect them to
do that. I
imagine
they'll do some. I highly doubt they'll do all of them.
Well, why couldn't they do all of them? This is what I don't understand. Why do some? I mean, where are they? Who are they deciding the sum is? I mean...
Why nerf Scorpions run
Cannibal? I guess that's what I expect. Whether they'll do it or not, no.
Like, you know.
The other thing is, well, I don't know. I think the other thing is, they'll probably. I think Liu Kang is going to be. Who's right, who was the character that squeezed by all the patches? Was it Cabal and Cyrax?
Yeah.
Right, Liu Kang is going to be that guy. Liu Kang's going to be that guy. All the patches are going to be over. And then at the end of the game, Liu Kang's going to be standing there going, check out all this bullshit I can do. And yeah. Once
I mean,
people get
maybe, about Liu maybe, Kang. But people know
I'm
now, we know.
Cyrax is my, I'm sorry, Liu Kang is my call for Cyrax, Cabal, and Sonya and Johnny Cage. Are going to slip by all the patches unnoticed because nobody's winning anything with them. And then I expect Bone Shaper to probably get touched. I expect Bone Shaper to totally be brought back. I expect, what else?
Predator, damage scaling on.
Predator, yeah, Predator, will, get, will, Predator get. Will get damage scaling. His Hunter Trap will go away on block.
Oh, I hope not.
His down one, yeah, will, no long, his down one will no longer be plus one. And I guess the only other thing is Tremor's generic projectiles will get buffed, and then he'll be a fucking disaster. He'll be
he'll be
the best character in the game if he gets his project. But I expect him to get his projectiles buffed. And I guess lastly, I expect
Lao's meterless damage to go down as well. Damage.
I don't think Tempest will change him.
No, they'll not change Tempest. They'll not change his damage. They'll not do any of that.
They're not touching him.
The character's just well designed, and there's nothing you can do about that. You can't design the character well and then punish him for it. Be like, he's too good. He makes sense. I mean, just his moveset makes sense more than.
That's the other thing about everything else, but his damage will get touched. Because if you look at the cast, if you look at the roster, there's not.
I don't know if I'd say Kung Lao's well designed. Like, he has everything.
He's perfectly designed. He is what I call. See, the best characters in this game are the ones I say have utility moves, right? What I mean by that is if you have a standard way of playing and all of a sudden the opponent's kind of half figured it out, you don't have to keep fucking doing that and you're just going to get busted for it. Kung Lao can decide, well, hold on, this isn't working. I might throw a couple of hats. I might do something, which is actually underrated. If the guy decides he's going to throw a projectile, he can teleport. He can start shenanigans. He can decide to
Kung
wait.
Kung Lao's hat is probably one of the better projectiles in this game.
He can decide to wait and go, okay, I'm gonna cool off and I'm gonna make you make mistakes and then I'm gonna meter burn spin you or I'm gonna anti-air. He can change what he does. He's a utility character. He's kind of like Aaron Black. Aaron Black's like the
Deathstroke of this game. This game, you know, so, is that well designed? Being like, is that what it means? I don't know about that.
What I mean, well designed, I mean like his move sets just work in the game where some characters just. For instance, Jim was talking about defensive characters. Like, for instance, this game doesn't work for me. I'm not great at it because it doesn't play to the way I play. Foxy, for instance, is what people would call a rushdown fool, right? He just likes to get in your face and beat the shit out of you, and it works in this game, and it rewards you in this game. Where for what I want to do, it doesn't even.
If you want to play defensive in this game, defense better be.
I thought Sub-Zero was going to play a certain way, and turns out he doesn't. Turns out you have to rush guys down, and just it's ridiculous. Hit them with a bunch of stuff, and I was like, you know what? There has to be a defensive character here that isn't just fireballs and rune traps. And I'm hoping maybe when a DLC comes out, I guess there might be more DLC. You never know. Maybe they might buff a variation that's defensive, and it might suit me. And basically, the only thing I'm saying is, there's not a defensive variation out there, the equivalent of an offensive variation. There's no defensive Tempest type of play where you can have the opponent not touch you for 30 seconds while building meter. Well, apart from HQ10, which is going to get nerfed to the
What's like? I was going to say, like, I was going to ask the question, what do you reckon is the best defensive variation?
That's a good question, yeah.
HQ10, straight away. You can't touch him. You can't touch him at all. The problem isn't that the problem isn't his zoning's too good or too fast. It's the recovery on the projectiles. So whenever you teleport or you make a read, he's recovering so quickly he can block, which he shouldn't be able to do.
Is that not six of one, half a dozen of the other? To say that a rush, to say that the opposite is a problem, but the defensive option's fine.
Yeah, but the bottom line is HQ10 totally ruins everything. It's not like it's just a little bit difficult to deal with, and maybe we'll learn. It's literally like you play against a player that knows what he's doing. Man, Forever King played against the Yomi guys, and he wiped them for about 2 hours. We're talking good players, like, and they couldn't get past the shit, and they play it every day. And I'm just saying that HQ10 is probably going to get touched. Predator in general. Patch, talking about the patch, Predator.
Hunter as well. No, you can't have that fucking, okay, I'm going to throw a trap. And now I'm either going to throw you or do something, and it's,
or do my overhead.
You're going to get caught. Yeah.
He can throw a trap down in the corner, and he can just block. Like even when you.
Yeah.
But like other moves, like here's what I personally think. Although Reese doesn't agree with me, right? Omega, I think Tremors, Rockshar is going to go away once you touch him. In any shape, because right now you can throw the Rockshar and you can run forward and punish him and it'll still hit you out
of
it. Which I know Tremor doesn't need.
That's dumb.
But that's
Overhead rocks.
That's dumb. Yeah. That's what I say. Just cover yourself with a rock everything you do. You can't really.
I mean, how many opponents are doing their first attack and it's pushing you a sweep distance away from where he was? Nothing. So
Tremor's still fairly new, though. I mean, he's not been out long. I did want to
think Tremor's retarded. Please. If you don't have a 7-frame move, you're in trouble.
Yeah, I kind of feel the same about Tremor. I do think Tremor's good. Foxy, what are you expecting in the patch? You kind of covered most of it. Anything you want to mention that you didn't?
I don't know. I just wait and see, because who knows? Like, I wasn't expecting Tempest when we got Tempest.
Oh god, that was.
Boxy, can you remember me and you sitting hype theory thinking about how Tempest was going to work, and we got it all wrong?
What, before the game came out? No, yeah, I thought Tempest would have been more like how it is now, but it wasn't.
We kind of had it all wrong. Remember, we thought
that was my theory. My theory was similar to how it is now, without the block pressure and all that shit.
Things,
I thought it'd be more like Batman.
There was things we thought were going to work, and they didn't. But we got it half right. I wish we could have recorded that, man. The things we predicted right and wrong were hilarious.
Alright, Gabe, seeing as you're back, what do you think? What are you expecting in the patch? What do you want? Then we'll wrap
what
up.
What do I want?
We're getting long. Yeah. What are you expecting, and then what do you want?
I would want...
Just say a 7-frame overhead. Just say a 7-frame on low roll. Or say, frame...
A low roll would be nice, just to see how T1...
A low roll, you can fuck right off.
Just to see how 2AM react, because there's a lot of people on there who thinks a low roll would be fine. They really don't know what they're smoking. But anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah,
what do you expect?
To be honest, I don't expect Molina to get, like, anything.
Unfortunately, I agree with you. I don't know why, but it's just a gut feeling.
All I would
agree. Yeah, I mean, if your animations ain't set to be good, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
So it doesn't even matter on, like, the frame data, except for like Katana, because her animations are okay, I guess.
Exactly. All I would really like maybe would just be a few frames shaved off some of her normals, so that she can actually play some footsies with some characters. But aside from that, I don't expect anything to happen with her.
Fair enough. 12 Gauge, what about you? And we'll wrap up.
I expect nothing to happen because nobody cares about Jax. Everybody thinks Jax is fucking super great character and nothing needs to be touched with him. So this is going to be the struggle for the rest of the game.
I love Jax. I love Jax. He is a great character to fight against. I love the part how he just struggles.
It's alright. The struggle will pay off at some point.
It won't. I play Kung Lao. Every game my character's in is really good.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, that's true.
But I think just like by the nature of his character, he can't be bad.
Hmm.
He's a fucking Shaolin monk with a hat and a teleport and a dive kick.
Yeah, he does kind of have a lot of bases covered. That's true. But anyway, anything you guys want to shout out or plug before we wrap up?
Red Fight District. We need to get all the Europeans there.
Yes. I'm totally going to that. I'm going to that.
And we need to shut down the Middle East. The Middle East are coming.
He's swear to some racist, man.
What, they want it. They want it. They want the revenge. But,
it's just strictly MK we're talking about, not anything political, by the way.
Yeah.
Just
I was saying about Tekken Master's friend put up the thread. But he's like, yeah, the Middle East invasion is coming, so we need to just get all PND there.
Yeah, I'm very, very possible I'll be going to that very likely.
It appears the only person that can stop PND is Sonic Fox, so
yep.
I don't really have much hopes for the Middle Eastern's chance to get through all of PND. But,
is Sonic Fox going to go to Red Fight District?
Nope.
Could do, but I doubt it. Yeah, you probably could be. Anybody else you want to shout out anything?
Shout outs to the Jack Struggle Dread. Shout outs. Anyone suffering the struggle? We have a helpline.
What is it?
Yeah, it's me. I'm your helpline.
The helpline is 1-800 off Jacks.
No, 1-800 over a dash punch pops up.
Oh God! If only.
It's probably too many.
Guys, do you know you can win a game with Jax by just pressing 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 throw? You know you can win a game doing that.
No, you can't. But we don't get it with 1-2.
Yeah, you can.
It's like picking Buzzsaw and doing low hat throw, low hat throw, low hat throw, overhead, low hat throw.
1-2 throw. You can win with 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 throw. 1 throw. You can do it. You start at an MK9, you'll do it.
1. Yeah, but that was the card I had. In MK9, I was stuck.
We're
going to
wrap up. Anyway, guys, we can carry this on. We're going to wrap up. So that does it for episode 15, guys. Thanks for tuning in. We will see you next time. Thanks for Foxy and Weave coming on. Catch you next time. Peace.